UAM would like to take a moment to celebrate the 50th year anniversary of Division II athletics to honor the thousands of student athletes, coaches, faculty, and administrators who have shaped this division over time. Here's the 50 more. Are only allowed on the premises. We ask that all fans act in a respectful and responsible manner to all. Any profanity exhibited by fans will not be tolerated and is grounds for removal. Thank you. at this time, we would like to recognize our football seniors for their hard work and dedication throughout their career. On the field to recognize them is head football coach Hud Jackson, his wife Patricia, and UAM Chancellor Dr. Peggy Doss. First is number three, a 2022 GAC All-Conference linebacker from Urbana, Arkansas, Demarius White. Demarius is a four-year letter winner, completing his bachelor's degree in health and physical education in the summer of 2023. He is currently seeking his master's degree in physical education and coaching, and he is set to graduate in the spring of 2025. In attendance with Demarius are his parents, Marcus and Andrea White, his sister, Jordan White, and his grandmother, Elizabeth White. Ladies and gentlemen, Demarius White. Next is number nine, defensive lineman from DeSoto, Texas, Theron Ballard. Theron is a two-year letter winner, graduating this spring with his bachelor's degree in health and physical education. In attendance with Theron is his father, Conrad Ballard, his mother, Bridget Broussard, brother David Broussard, sister Christy Broussard, and his niece Jalea. Ladies and gentlemen, Theron Ballard. Next is number 22 defensive back from Waco, Texas, Demarion Holmes. Demarion is a two-year letter winner and is graduating with a bachelor's degree in interdisciplinary studies with an emphasis in criminal justice in the December of 2023. Walking with Demarion today is his position coach and defensive coordinator, Coach Steve Wright. Ladies and gentlemen, Demarion Holmes! Next is number 26, running back from Santa Clara, California, Gary Furman. Gary is a two-year letter winner who is set to receive his bachelor's degree in exercise science in December of 2023. In attendance with him today are his parents, Javier and Maria Cessna. Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Furman. Next is number 28, linebacker from Smithville, Arkansas, Curtis Jones. Curtis earned his bachelor's degree in animal science this past spring of 2023 and is currently seeking his certificate in forestry business to be completed in the spring of 2025. In attendance with Curtis is his wife, Laura, his parents, Tracy and Misty Jones, and his brother, Jacob. Ladies and gentlemen, Curtis Jones! Next is number 70, offensive lineman from Austin, Texas, Tyler Castaneda. Tyler is a three-year letter winner receiving a bachelor's degree in health and physical education, graduating this spring of 2024. In attendance with Tyler are his parents, Robert and Misty Castaneda, and his brothers, Caleb and Brandon Castaneda. Ladies and gentlemen, Tyler Castaneda. Next is number 89, tied in from Church Point, Louisiana, Ian Mann. Ian is a four-year letter winner, graduating with a bachelor's degree in exercise science in December of 2022. Ian is currently seeking a master's degree in physical education and coaching and will graduate this spring in 2024. In attendance with Ian are his parents, Keith and Denise Mesh. Ladies and gentlemen, Ian Mesh! Thank you. Next is number 92 defensive lineman from also American Samoa, Maurice Lotavai. Maurice is a two-year letter winner working on his bachelor's degree in health and physical education. Maurice is set to graduate in the spring of 2024. Walking with Maurice today is his position coach, Coach Nate Nelson. Ladies and gentlemen, Maurice Lotavai. Next is number 93, kicker from Anaheim, California, Zachary Gascotti. Zachary is a two-year letter winner completing his bachelor's degree in finance this December 2023. Zachary plans on getting his master's degree in finance from the University of Southern California. In attendance with Zachary are his parents, Phil and Lisa Gascotti, sisters Allie, Sam, and Bella Gascotti, grandparents Gene and Juanita, and his girlfriend Julia. Ladies and gentlemen, Zachary Gascotti! Our final senior being recognized today is defensive lineman number 42 from Edmond, Oklahoma, Michael Pope. Michael is joined today by his father, Myron Pope, his stepmom, Shayna Pope, his mom, Julian Pope, his stepdad, Eugene Jackson, his brother, Isaiah Pope, and his girlfriend, Kate. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause for Michael Pope. In addition, at this time, we would like to recognize our senior cheerleader, Kelly Jo Stain. Kelly Jo is a four-year veteran cheerleader. She currently serves as co-captain and has held the position of game day leader and academic chair. Kelly Jo is graduating with a degree in psychology. After graduation in May, she plans to apply to graduate school and pursue a master's degree in clinical and mental health counseling. Joining her on the field today are her parents, Stephen and Tammy Stain. Ladies and gentlemen, senior Kelly Jo Stain. Well, let's give a big round of applause to all of our seniors. Thank you for your service to UAM and best of luck in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Southeast Arkansas, your 2023 Bald Eagle Marching Band. Led by drum major Anna Stinnett from McQueen, Arkansas, on behalf of the University of Arkansas at Monticello, the Bald Eagle Marching Band greets all fans with a special welcome to the faculty, administration, students, alumni, and friends. Fans, we ask at this time that you please rise and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem, conducted by Director of Bands, Dr. Kristen Zelnick. Thank you. coach here. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Thor Weevil Marching Band!
And a very pleasant good afternoon. Welcome to UAM football, another great American Conference matchup here this afternoon as the Weevils get set to take on Southern Nazarene. They come in at 4-5 on the season, while the Weevils are 2-7 as they host them here at Convoy Leslie Stadium here this afternoon. And it is, let's see, I think it is the eighth meeting between the two. Yep, no, it's the ninth meeting, I'm sorry. UAM sits ahead of the all-time series, 8-1 against Southern Nazarene. Since the teams first met in 2013, the Weevils are 5-0 against the Crimson Storm here at Willis-Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. The first match since their first matchup, UAM looks to take down Southern Nazarene here for the sixth time since 2017. The last time these two teams met back in 2022, it was a 40-26 matchup. The Weevils offense dominated the opening quarter, leading 21-0. And it was in the second quarter before the Crimson Storm found their first points. UAM had 538 total yards in offense, but we had quarterback Demian Brown, who passed for 228 yards and went 12 for 28 in that game. He also led UAM in the running game, rushing for 149 yards on 13 attempts. We will miss him, as we have since he went out with an injury. Also, Isaiah Cross was questionable coming into today's game. I don't think he'll play either. He was the leading receiver a year ago, as he had three passes for 97 yards against the Crimson Storm a year ago, but he's not available today as either. As you probably heard on the coach's show with Coach Jackson, we have a lot of young players that are going to be playing here this afternoon that played last week as well. The Crimson Storm have won the opening toss, and they have deferred to the second half, so they will get the football in the second half. UAM's offense is going to be out on the field. We'll take a break, and we'll come back with the kickoff of today's ball game when we return in just a moment.
Are y'all ready?
sure to get all of your UAM Athletics gear at the Quick Store kiosk that is located on the home side of the main concourse. It's open until the end of halftime, so get your gear and show off your UAM family.
Greg Hooks and Joshua McGarty will go back deep for the Weevils as this ball game is just about set to kick off. Weevils are going to be moving from right to left on your radio dial from south to north here at Convoy Leslie Cottonbow Stadium. High kickoff going to be fielded, looks like by Greg Hooks, back at the 5, up to the 10, the 15, hit at the 20-yard line, and that's as far as he'll go. And that's where the Weevil offense will come out onto the field for their first possession of the afternoon here on a beautiful, beautiful day in southeast Arkansas. Game time temperature 75 degrees, and the Weevils take to the field. Getting the start this afternoon at quarterback will be Austin Wadsworth, a true freshman, fresh out of high school last year from Pearl River, Louisiana. He'll get the start at quarterback. It looks like Glenn Cage will get the start at running back to start this afternoon. Cage, seen him several times. He's a true freshman out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Twin receivers on either side. Wadsworth wanting to throw on first down. Looking, has time, wanting to go deep down the field for Arlie Lee. It is caught in and out of his hands. He had it for a second at the 40-yard line of Southern Nazarene, but couldn't hold on. Oh, my. Nicely thrown ball, though, from Wadsworth. The incomplete pass will bring up second down and 10, but the Weevils wanting to go vertical on the first play from the line of scrimmage. On second down and 10. Wadsworth again out of the shotgun. This time he's going to hand play action. Throws it over the middle. This one's complete. Out over the 30, 35. Out over the 40. Out close to the 46-yard line. And making the catch there, Giovanni Gibson, the wide receiver, a freshman out of Opelousa, Louisiana. That'll move the chains. It'll be a first down for the Weevils out at the 45-yard line. First and 10. Hurry up offense. They quickly snap the football. Hand it off to Cage. Cage straight ahead. He'll push the pile forward out across midfield all the way down to the Crimson Storm 48-yard line. And the Weevils will look at second down and 3 from the 48-yard line of the Crimson Storm. Four-man front defensively. UAM hurry up offense. Again, hand off to Cage. Cage gets a yard, maybe two. He's going to be a yard shy of the first down. So we'll call it third down and 1. Now for the Weevils. Ball spotted on the right hash mark. And here come the big tight ends into the ball game. Checking in for UAM, it'll be Ben Colligan. Also going in, Ian Mesh. And we'll put Arlie Lee back there as the Wild Weevil. He'll get the direct snap. Two tight ends, an H-back, twin receivers come wide left. Arlie Lee, your quarterback for the moment. Takes the snap, goes straight ahead, lowers his shoulder, and I don't think he got it. It'll depend on the spot. He's just shy of the 40-yard line is where they're marking the football. I believe he needed to get to the 40 for the 45 for the first down. They're going to eye it and say, no, it's first down. Trying to move the chains. First and 10, Weevils. Their second of the afternoon here on this opening drive. 13:08 to play. First quarter, we have no score. First and 10, Weevils at the Crimson Storm 45-yard line. Wadsworth calling for the snap. Hands it off to Cage again. Cage breaks one tackle at the line. Down inside the 40, all the way down to the 39-yard line. That'll be a gain of 6 on the play by Glenn Cage. And bring up a second down and a long 4 now for UAM. Wadsworth, the true freshman. Signal caller this afternoon for the Weevils. UAM will shift the tight end and ace back to the wide side of the field on the left. They're going to hand it off to Cage, straight ahead, right side. He's got the first down as he goes inside the 35 to the 30, all the way down to the 29-yard line. Cage moves the chains again as he lowers his shoulder and gets the first down yardage. They're marking squarely on the 30-yard line. First and 10, Weevils. Say it in the hurry-up offense. Up-tempo. Coach Qualls calling the play in from the sideline. They put Gibson in motion. He'll line up in a bunch set on the left, wanting to throw. Looking. Now trouble coming from the backside and going to be sacked as Wadsworth's going to go down. Back at the 38-yard line is where they're marking down on the sack. It's going to be a loss of 8 on the play and bring up second down and 18. Arlie Lee will check in. He'll go as a wide receiver, wide to the right. Gibson's out there with him. Here on the near side to us is Jordan Mansfield and Caleb Jacobs. So second down and 18 for the Weevils now from the Crimson Storm, 38-yard line. Wadsworth, they'll rush 4. Late blitz coming. He dumps it off to Cage out of the backfield. Makes one man miss. He's down to the 30. Gets it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Nice gain of 9 yards on the play, but it'll bring up a third down and long here with 10:52 to play in the opening quarter. Opening drive of the ball game. We will start it at their own 20-yard line. Looking at third down and 9 now from the Storm 29-yard line. Coach Qualls taking his time, looking over the defense. He'll call the play here on 3rd and 9. Twin receivers to either side. Wadsworth out of the gun. Wadsworth leaves it with Cage again. Cage, not much there. He'll get it down maybe to the 28.5 as he's met hard by the linebacker coming up for the Crimson Storm, and that is Brock Carter. So Weevil's looking at 4th down. We'll call it 4th down and 9. All right, let's get this fire. From just inside the 29-yard line of the Storm. They're going to go for it. Trip receivers go wide right. One receiver comes wide left for the Weevils. Wadsworth, straight drop, steps up, fires into the flat. It's complete to Caleb Jacobs. He is hit and going to be stopped short of the first down at the 25-yard line, and that's where the Crimson Storm will take over on downs. At their own 25-yard line, with 9:42 to play here in the opening quarter, we have no score here at Convoy Leslie Cottonbow Stadium. Yeah, beautiful afternoon, 75 degrees at kickoff. Just a few clouds in the sky, but boy, what a great afternoon for college football. First and 10 for the Crimson Storm. Their quarterback is Gage Porter. He's one of those graduate seniors, been around. I think this is his 6th year. He got redshirted and then COVIDed out during the year. So his 6th year as quarterback. Throws, it's complete to the tight end over the middle, out over the 30, out to the 31-yard line. As making the catch out there is going to be Robert Asa. How about Asa Robertson? A gain of about 6 on the play. So it'll be 2nd down and 4 now for the Storm. They'll stay out of the shotgun. They have trip backs in the backfield. Almost like an inverted wishbone. Porter, the quarterback, takes the snap. Going to keep it himself. He's in trouble, and he's going to be sacked back at the 25-yard line. And coming up with the sack is Arlie Alfraney Hankins. That'll be a loss of six on the play. So it'll be third down and 10 now for the Crimson Storm with 8:50 to play here in the opening quarter. No score. Third down and 10 from their own 25-yard line, back at the original line of scrimmage. Storm brings in a package with twin wide receivers wide to the right. Two tight ends wide to the left. Porter, play action. Rolling to his right, in trouble, unloads it down the field, and it's going to be incomplete out near midfield. Defending on the play for UAM was Jalen Gillier, the defensive back over there, the freshman out of Mattery, Louisiana. Ball was underthrown, so the Crimson Storm will have to punt it away on their first possession. 8:22 to play. Weevils are going to get it back. Caleb Jacobs is going to go back deep to return for the Bull Weevils. Their punter gets the punt off, end-over-end kick. Jacob's going to pick it up at the 35, return it up to the 40, 45. Caleb over midfield, and he'll return it inside Storm territory all the way back to the 45-yard line. 20-yard return on the punt following a 43-yard punt. The Weevils have it first and 10. At the Crimson Storm 45-yard line with 8:10 to play here in the first quarter. Weevils will have the football in very good field position. They'll stay with Wadsworth at quarterback. Got a new running back this series. It's Gary Furman. Furman, the senior out of Santa Ana, California. He'll line up in the pistol formation behind Wadsworth. Going to leave it with Furman. Furman trying to find a hole there at the line. He's going to get a yard, and that's about all, maybe two, down to the 43-yard line. That'll bring up a second down and 8 now for the Bull Weevils. Ball spotted at the 43-yard line of Southern Nazarene. Weevils in their white pants, black jerseys, green numerals outlined in white, and white helmets today. Crimson Storm, their maroon pants and white jerseys. Wadsworth wanting to throw. Fires. This one's complete inside the 35. Hit immediately down at the 32-yard line. Now they're going to rule it incomplete. They lost a handle on it when it came down. Didn't have control of it. The receiver that time was Giovanni Gibson. He's trying to plead his case along with the coaches for UAM. They're going to rule it incomplete. So it'll be third down and 8 now for UAM. Trip receivers will come wide left. One goes wide right. It's Mansfield over there in the short side of the field. Ball on the right hash mark. On third down and 8, Wadsworth. Straight drop, blitz coming. He flushed out of the pocket, running to his left. Throws, it's going to be incomplete as he underthrows. Running to his right, or his left, right-handed passer. Didn't ever get a chance to set up and put anything on the football. It'll fall incomplete, and that'll bring up a fourth down and 8 for the Weevils from the 43-yard line of the Crimson Storm. And we'll see the punt team come on. As Zachary Grassotti, one of the seniors that was recognized here this afternoon, as this is senior day on the UAM campus. 7:18 to play in the opening quarter. We have no score. Weevils will punt it for the first time today. Good snap, no pressure. Grassotti's going to try to pin him back deep. He angles it toward the sideline. This one hits at the 18, takes a Weevil roll inside the 15, all the way down to the 10. And that's where the Crimson Storm will start. A beautiful punt by Grassotti. Pins them back inside right at the 10-yard line. Excuse me. And that's where the Crimson Storm will have their second possession of the afternoon. As they went three and out on their first possession. We'll see if the Weevil defense can maintain that position and force them on a short three and out again. Final home game of the regular season here this afternoon. We're back on the road next week as we travel over to Magnolia to take on Southern Arkansas. That'll be the Battle of the Timberlands. Next Saturday, we'll have the broadcast for you right here on KHBM 93.7, your home of UAM Sports. 2 o'clock kickoff next Saturday. We'll be on the air at 1:30 with the pregame show and 2 o'clock with the kickoff next week. We've got 7:06 remaining here in the first quarter, no score. Weevils on their first possession started at their own 20, turned it over on downs down at the Crimson Storm 25. Crimson Storm went three and out, had a good return from Caleb Jacobs up to the 45-yard line of the Crimson Storm, but Weevils' offense goes three and out and has to punt it away. Well, that's where we stand, nothing, nothing. Now the Crimson Storm offense will come out onto the field. They'll stay with Gage Porter, their quarterback, 5'11", 225-pound graduate senior out of Elk City, Oklahoma. He'll work with an empty backfield and five wide. Puts a tight end in motion, hands it to him on a jet sweep around the end. Out over the 15, out close to the 20-yard line, and finally ridden out of bounds. As coming up to make the stop for the Bow Weevils, that's Jalen Gilliard. Ball carrier that time for Southern Nazarene was Donald May, a sophomore wide receiver out of Ardmore. And that's good for a first down, 11 yards, make it 12 yards on the play. It'll be first and 10 now for the Crimson Storm out at their own 22-yard line. They'll go with twin backs in the backfield this time. Put one of them in motion to the wide side of the field. Throw the wide receiver screen out there. It's got to be complete out over the 20 and hit it to 21. And coming up to make the stop for the Bow Weevils there is Demarius White, the leading tackler on this UAM squad. They're going to mark it back at the 21-yard line. So that's going to be a loss of one. Demarius, another one of those seniors out there for the Bow Weevils. Three-year letterman out of Smackover, Arkansas. Second down and 11 now for the Crimson Storm from their own 21-yard line. The running back is Aaron Fellows on second and 11. Now whistles blow and didn't see a flag anywhere, but they'll call the timeout. As now they're going to blow it back in play. Guess everybody's set. Second down and 11 for the Crimson Storm. Porter again out of the shotgun. Fellows the lone setback. Going to fake it. He'll keep it himself. Straight ahead out over the 30, 35, 40. Midfield cuts back at the 45. It's going to be run out of bounds in Weevil territory at the 39-yard line. Gage Porter, just a straight quarterback draw, and he had a big hole right up the middle. There was nobody home in the secondary. And he'll move the chains all the way down to the Weevil 39-yard line. They'll go up tempo, back on the line of scrimmage. Porter takes the snap, wanting to throw, has time. Now forced out of the pocket, running to his left. May have been across the line of scrimmage. He throws it up. It's going to be batted away at the last second by UAM. Down there near the goal line is making the play was Astrine Duncan, a defensive back, a sophomore out of Raceland, Louisiana. He was very close to being across the line of scrimmage when he threw that football. It'll bring up second down and 10 now from the Weevil 39-yard line. We're down to 5:13 left to play here in the opening quarter. We have no score. The Crimson Storm will send twin receivers wide to the right, a tight end of that side as well. Ball on the left hash mark. Twin backs in the backfield. Handed off to the left half back. He's going to be caught in the backfield and slung down. And who else on the play for the Weevils but Demarius White? Wow. That'll be a loss all the way back to the 44-yard line. So a loss of five on the play. It'll bring up third down and 15 now for Southern Nazarene. Third and 15, ball spotted back at the Weevil 44-yard line. The Crimson Storm now not in that hurry up there, standing back here looking into the sideline, getting the plays called in. Play clock down to 8. They come to the line of scrimmage. Porter looking over the defense. Weevil's in a four-man front. They'll rush four. They've got pressure on him. Going to be hit. The ball's loose on the ground. It's still loose. A scramble for it at the 42. UAM says they have it, and they do. Weevils come up with the fumble recovery. They knocked it out of the hands of Gage Porter, and UAM will take over at the 43-yard line, their own 43 here with 4:17 to play. First turnover of the ball game by either squad. And the Weevils are going to get it back. But not before we have a timeout on the field. We'll take it with them with 4:17 to play in the quarter. Nothing, nothing, our score. We're back in just a moment.
Fans, remember that UAM is a smoke-free and alcohol-free campus. Use of these products is strictly prohibited anywhere on campus grounds, including here at Cottonwood Stadium. In accordance with NCAA rules, artificial noisemakers and air horns are not permitted. We'd also like to remind you that the playing surface and the sidelines are strictly reserved for game participants and event staff only. Any use of profanity is not tolerated. Any violators of these policies may be removed from the facility.
The Weevils recover the fumble. It'll be first and 10 for UAM at their own 43-yard line. First turnover of the ball game by either squad. 4:17 remaining here in the opening period. We have no score. UAM will get the football for the third time this afternoon. Wadsworth stays in at the quarterback spot. Clint Gage is the running back. He'll line up at tailback. Twin receivers go wide right, one into the boundary. Ball on the left hash mark. Handoff. Nope, make it Wadsworth keeps it, rolls to his right, throws complete to Arlie Lee across midfield to the 45. Ball comes loose as he hits the turf. They're going to rule it down at the 42-yard line of the Crimson Storm. That'll move the chains and be a first down for the Bull Weevils. And we got an injured player for the Crimson Storm back up near midfield. It's going to be number 44, Jesse Fairchild. Redshirt freshman, plays defensive end out of Longview. Well, he was favoring his right ankle. Trainer's going to come out and check on him. Weevils will have it first and 10 when play resumes at the Crimson Storm 41-yard line. Exactly 4 minutes left to play here in this first quarter. No score. Neither team has really threatened yet. UAM turned it over at the Storm 25-yard line on their first possession. The Storm made it into UAM territory and fumbled the football at the 43-yard line. Actually, there's two players down on the field, one for UAM and one for the Crimson Storm. Looks like the one for UAM is going to be Keith Wells Jr., the freshman out of right here in Monticello. Trainers are looking at him, too. He's over on the far sideline beyond the hash mark, right in front of the Southern Nazarene bench. As they're checking on him, they're going to get him up on his feet. You look at him, he says he's 6'1", 250 pounds. He's favoring his left leg. During that injury timeout, you had a chance for Austin Wadsworth, the quarterback, to come over and talk with the offensive coordinator, Coach Qualls, over here. He'll trot back out onto the field. Is that going to help Wells off the field? Favoring, not very gingerly, not putting any weight on his left leg. It'll be first and 10 Bull Weevils from the Storm, 41-yard line here. 4 minutes left to play in the opening quarter. We have no score. Make sure the number I had was right on the injured player. That's actually Joshua Denton, number 88 instead of 98. Joshua Denton. They'll get him off. Now back to action. Cage gets the handoff straight ahead. He's inside the 40 all the way down to the Storm 37-yard line. Gain of 4 on the play. Second down and 6 now for the Weevils. They'll stay in the up-tempo as they look into the sideline to Coach Qualls. Twin receivers stay wide right. That's going to be Arley Lee split out here with Giovanni Gibson. Again, the handoff goes straight ahead. Cage this time met in the backfield for a loss. Back to the 40-yard line. Wow. They'll mark it at the 40, so it'll be third down and 9 for UAM. That time, that interior line for the Crimson Storm had the penetration, and they met Cage in the backfield. Third down and long from the 41 of the Crimson Storm. Trip receivers come wide left. One goes wide right. Wadsworth calling for the signal. Gets the snap. Has time. Looking. Throws underneath. It's complete to Mansfield. It'll be a short completion. Only down to the 33. Make it the 37-yard line of Southern Nazarene. Going to be well short of the first down and bring up a fourth down and 7 for UAM as they'll send the punting unit back on to try to pin the Storm back deep once again. Back to return is Joa Flores. Rosati comes on to punt it. He'll be punting from just about midfield when he boots it away. Kind of pooch kicks it, a high kick in the air. Fair catch is going to be called for up at the 16-yard line, and that's where the Crimson Storm will start first and 10 for their third possession of the afternoon from their own 16-yard line with a minute 58 to play in the third, or in the first quarter, make it in the first quarter. We have no score. Again, the third possession of the afternoon for Southern Nazarene. Their offense will come out led by Gage Porter, the graduate senior, at quarterback. See who his running back is going to be this time. His running back is Carlos Zapita. He's a graduate junior, says 5'7", 210. He'll line up in the pistol formation behind Porter. Porter hands it off to him. It's going to be out close to the 17, a gain of a couple of yards on the play, make it the 18-yard line. Coming up to make the stop for the Boll Weevils that time is going to be Michael McCorvey. Gain of only 2. We'll call it second down and 8. They'll go stay in the hurry up. Back to the line of scrimmage. Porter puts a man in motion. This time he'll keep it himself. Porter straight ahead. He's across the 20 out to the 25-yard line. So he's going to gain about 8 on the play. We'll make it 7 on the play. It'll be third down and 1. So third and 1 now for the Crimson Storm from their own 25-yard line. Third down and 1. Twin receivers go wide left. One comes wide right. The H-back lined up to the wide side as well. On third down and 1. Porter keeps it himself. Dives across the 25. He'll be very close to the first down at the 26-yard line. It'll depend on the spot. I don't think he's got it. Nope, they say he does. So move the chains. It'll be a first down for the Storm as they keep the drive alive here with 40 seconds to go in the first period. No score. Zapita, the running back. Gage Porter, your quarterback for the Crimson Storm. On first and 10, ball on the right hash mark. Puts another receiver in motion. This time hands it to him on a jet sweep. Turns the corner out over the 30, 35, 40. It's a foot race. He's not going to go far. He'll get to the 40, down and pushed out of bounds, down around the 35-yard line. As on the run that time was Aaron Fellows. Weevils were able to chase him down, but a big gain all the way down to the Weevil 35-yard line. Four seconds remain. Clock continues to count. See if they get the playoff. Nope, that's going to be the end of the first quarter. It is scoreless here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Nothing, the Crimson Storm. When we come back to start the second period, we'll have it first and 10 at the Weevil 35-yard line as we get set for the second 15 minutes of football here this afternoon. Don't go anywhere. More UAM football coming up next.
Please support our student athletes with this major facility improvement and upgrade. For more information on Legacy Campaign and how to donate, please contact the UAM Athletics Office at 870-460-1157 for more information.
Nothing, our score, as we've got 15 minutes in the books already here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Southern Nazarene will have it first and 10 at the Weevil 35-yard line. Right now, UAM with four first downs. The Crimson Storm with four. They have rushed for 89 yards. The Weevils have rushed for 20, passing the Weevils 56, Southern Nazarene 5. Porter is the quarterback, 'Gage Porter, for the Storm. He'll take the snap, going to hand it off on an end around. That's going to be to 'Aza Robinson. Robinson inside the 30, the 25. It's going to be finally bumped out of bounds, way down in Weevil territory. See if they mark him down at the 16-yard line. Make it the 17-yard line. That'll move the chains again. It'll be a first down now at the 17-yard line. The first team to reach the red zone here this afternoon is the Crimson Storm of Southern Nazarene. They go with twin receivers, wide right. One comes wide left. The lone setback in the backfield alongside Porter is Jarvis Davis. Put the tight end in motion to the wide side of the field. Davis takes a direct snap, wanting to throw it. Running forced out of the pocket, has a man open down at the 4-yard line. He'll make the catch and go out of bounds, as that was the tight end who came around and hung around over there on the sideline to make the catch, Daylon Smith. And that'll be first and goal to goal now for the Crimson Storm down at the 4-yard line of UAM. And quickly they go back to the line of scrimmage. They'll leave Jarvis in at the quarterback. He'll get the snap, hands it off. Nope, fakes it, keeps it himself. Right side, touchdown, Crimson Storm. You had 'Gage Porter lined up at the tailback. He's normally their quarterback. And they moved Jarvis Davis in. He took the direct snap, went over the right side for the 4-yard touchdown run. And the Crimson Storm have taken a 6-0 lead here with 13:50 left to play in the opening quarter. The extra point kicker is Adam Atwell. The snap is down. The kick is on its way. And this one is good. 7-0 our score. The Crimson Storm have the lead here to start the second quarter. We'll be back after this timeout. $13.50 to play here in the first half. It's 7-0. The Crimson Storm have taken the lead there. As see if we can get the scoring drive for them. It's capped off with a 4-yard run by Jarvis Davis. Ended up being an 11-play drive. Covered 52 yards and the touchdown. Weevils get set to return the kickoff. Hooks will be on one side for the Weevils and Harley Lee on the other side. Second quarter, 13:50 to play. End over end kick. Harley Lee's going to take it at the 1. He'll return it up to the 10, the 15. Going to get it back to the 20-yard line, and that's it. A 19-yard return on the kickoff, and the Weevils will start first and 10 at their own 19. How about number 6 on the return? That's A.J. Bullock on the return for UAM. So the Weevil offense will need to get something going now. Trailing 7-0. We'll see Gary Furman in at the tailback spot. They're staying with Wadsworth. His third, make it 4 series to be at the quarterback spot. Caleb Jacobs comes in motion to the wide side of the field on the right. Wadsworth wanting to throw, looking, has all day. Now he's forced out of the pocket. Wadsworth going to be caught behind the line of scrimmage and dropped back at the 18-yard line. Going to be a loss of 2 on the play. Had all day to get rid of it, just couldn't find anywhere to go with it. The pocket finally collapsed on him. So that'll bring up a 2nd down. So he's spotted out at the 19, so it'll be 2nd down and 11. Ian Mesh in at the tight end spot on the short side of the field. Ball on the right hash mark. Again, he wanted to throw. This is complete to Mesh out to 20. Gets it across the 25. Hit and knocked out of bounds up at the 28-yard line. Going to be a couple of yards shy of the first down. Bring up a 3rd down, though, and a manageable 2 now for the Weevils. They'll stay in the hurry-up offense. Back up on the line of scrimmage. Wadsworth calls for the snap, hands it off straight ahead. Furman. Furman breaks a tackle at the 30. He's at the 35, out over the 40, out to the 42-yard line. Gary Furman on the nice run right up the middle. That'll move the chains and be a big first down for the Boll Weevils. Marking out at their own 42-yard line. Weevils snap the football. Wardenburg wanting to throw. Now forced out of the pocket, running to his left. A flag comes in. He's going to be sacked back at the 38-yard line. Coming up to make sure he didn't go anywhere was Carter Brock, the linebacker. But there is a flag on the play, and that's in the area of a hold. Flag is back at the 35-yard line of UAM. See if we can get where, what they're going to say. The official's microphone will work this afternoon.
Holding number 66 of the offense. Penalties declined. Result of play is now 2nd down.
So the Nazarene will decline the holding call, so there'll be the Weevils football. There's a loss of 4 on the play back to the 37-yard line. It'll be 2nd down and 14 for UAM. 12:05 to play in the first half. 7-0 our score. Southern Nazarene leads it. The Crimson Storm in a 4-man front defensively. Wadsworth takes the snap. Play action. Throws this one. Going to be caught somehow by the Weevils. And making the catch there is going to be Giovanni Gibson. The ball actually hit the defender in the shoulder pad. Went right up in the air. And Gibson was able to keep his concentration and his eye on the football to make the catch up at the 48-yard line. A gain of 6 on the play. Be 3rd down and 4. Jordan Mansfield splits wide to the right into the boundary. Arlie Lee and Gibson split wide left. Wadsworth again out of the shotgun once again for the Boll Weevils. Puts Lee in motion. Going to hand it off to him on the end around. He'll get it up near midfield. Another flag comes in at the end of the run. A short gain of only one on the play. Weevils would have been looking at fourth down and three. We'll see what the penalty is about. And again, it's in the area of a holding call. Not good news for UAM. All right, let's see.
Holding, number 56 of the offense. Penalty's declined, and it's fourth down.
The Storm's going to decline the penalty. It'll bring up a fourth down and three for UAM. Ball spotted right up near midfield. And once again, the Weevils are going to send on the punting unit to punt it away. Trailing 7-0 with 11:04 to go here in the first half. Zachary Grisotti comes on to punt it away. Back deep for the Crimson Storm, Joa Flores. Wide snap. Grisotti runs it down, an end-over-end kick, going to hit at the 20. And picked up there by Southern Nazarene, returned to the 25-yard line. As that was Weston Smith, that ball bounced right to him as he was running down the field after it hit the ground. Short return of 3 yards, and the Storm will have it first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. With 10:45 to play here in the first half, 7-0, our score, Southern Nazarene with the lead.
There you can sign up for email alerts, find the latest game previews, and recaps as well.
Right now, UAM, 100 and
live coverage. Catch UAM Athletics on
get it down here.
Instagram, YouTube.
There you go, 106 yards total offense. Southern Nazarene, 129 total yards of offense here in the first half so far. Official timeout down on the field. Now the teams make their way back out. We'll be set for play. First and 10 from their own 25 for the Crimson Storm. 10:45 to play in the first half. Southern Nazarene leads it by 7. Gage Porter, the quarterback, said he's been around for at least 6 years there at Southern Nazarene. He had a red shirt and in the COVID year. He's kind of like Demaryon Brown, but he has been able to stay healthy. Porter out of the shotgun. Puts a flanker in motion. That is Gerald Farr. Little shuttle pass complete to the tight end over the middle. Wide open at the 40. Midfield, the 40, down to the 30. The 20, caught from behind at the 10 and drug down inside the 5 at the 4-yard line. Finally chasing him down and keeping him from going into the end zone was Ashton Duncan, the defensive back. Well, that tight end was wide open. The safeties had sold out on the run. There was nobody there, and it was almost a shuttle pass. Quickly back to the line of scrimmage. Porter, bunch set to the right. And now flags come in before the snap.
First down, number 77 of the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So a false start on the offense. That'll back them up 5. Instead of first and goal from the 4, it's going to be first and goal from about the 9-yard line, it looks like, for the Crimson Storm. 10:13 to play before halftime. They lead at 7-0, and they're knocking on the door. First and goal from the 9. Porter will have one back in the backfield, and that is Angel Ramirez. He'll line up on the right side of Porter. Twin receivers to either side. Porter now puts Farr in motion, fakes it to him. Porter keeps it himself. He's inside the 5, going to be hit at the 5, still standing on his feet. Powell still going forward. They're going to finally shove him back, and I believe they're going to call this forward progress down at the 3-yard line. So a gain of 6 on that play. It'll be second and goal from the 3 now for the Crimson Storm. They'll spot it at the 3-yard line, second and goal from the 3. It's a Storm now looking into the sideline, waiting on the play to be called in. They'll send the tight end out as a wide out this time. Twin receivers come wide left as well. Porter stays in at the quarterback spot. The tailback is Ramirez. Second and goal from the 3. Far in motion. They fake it to him. Porter keeps it straight ahead himself. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Crimson Storm. Gage Porter with the rushing touchdown puts the Storm up 13-0 here in the first half with 8:59 to play, and the extra point coming now for Southern Nazarene. as everybody gets set. The holder is there. Adam Atwell will attempt the extra point. Snaps down, kicks on its way, and it is good. 14 to nothing. The Weevils trail the Southern Nazarene Crimson Storm, and we'll be back with more UAM football right after this timeout.
Fans, your Bowling football team will close out the 2023 schedule as they travel to Magnolia for the Battle of the Timberlands Trophy against Southern Arkansas University next Saturday, November 11th. Kickoff is scheduled for 2 p.m.
The Crimson Storm have extended their lead, 8:59 to play here in the first half. They'll kick it off once again, and this one's going to be fielded at the 3 and returned by the Weevils up to the 10, up to the 15, and that's as far as we'll go this time. It's a great coverage down the field by the special teams for Southern Nazarene. And UAM will start at their own 15-yard line with the offense that's put 106 yards and 24 plays on here on the ground, or total offense this afternoon. Crimson Storm have run 19 plays for 209 total yards on the afternoon. First and 10 Weevils from their own 15-yard line. Wadsworth stays in at the quarterback. This series we will see Glenn Cage in at the running back spot on first down. Handed off to Cage, left side. It's a pile up there. No gain on the play as Cage ran into a brick wall. There was nothing there. It'll bring up second down and 10 now for the Weevils. Let's back up on the quarterback. The quarterback now is Caden Middleton for UAM. Caden, a freshman, went to Ruston, Louisiana High School. Cage in, stays in at the tailback spot. Middleton takes the snap, looking to throw, fires a quick one over the middle. It's complete to Arlie Lees, out over the 25, the 30, going to be out to the 32-yard line before he's finally knocked down. Got to move the chains, and it'll be a first down for the Weevils out at their own 32-yard line. They go up-tempo, right back to the line of scrimmage. Twin receivers wide right and wide left. Middleton throwing again, complete to Arlie Lee. Catches it and slips down out at the 35-yard line. They'll mark it at the 36 to say where he slipped down at. So that'll be a gain of 4 on the play and bring up second down and 6 now for the Weevils. Giovanni Gibson and Arlie Lee split wide to the left. Caleb Jacobs and Mansfield come wide right. Middleton looking over the defense as they'll rush four, make a late blitz coming. He unloads it toward the sideline. It's going to be caught by Caleb Jacobs out here at the 47-yard line, and that'll be another first down. Middleton was just really trying to throw it away. The ball stayed in play in the field of play, and Caleb Jacobs alert enough to come up and come back and make the catch for the Weevil. So first and 10, UAM out at their own 47-yard line with just under 7 minutes to play here in the first half. The Crimson Storm leading 14 to nothing. Trip receivers go wide left. Ball's going to be on the right hash mark for UAM on first and 10. Middleton again checking the defense. Again, they rush four. Middleton steps up in the pocket, fires, has Jacobs complete at midfield. He'll turn it up inside the 45, or knocked out of, stepped out of bounds at the 45-yard line of the Crimson Storm. A gain of 8 on the play. It'll be second down and 2 now for the Bowl Weevils. So second and 2. They stay with trip receivers, this time wide to the right. Ball on the left hash mark this time. Middleton looking right, throwing underneath. It's going to be underthrown. And Tindall down here from Mansfield out at the 42-yard line. The ball underthrown. So the Weevils will look at third down and two from the Storm, 45-yard line. And here comes the big tight ends in. Ian Mesh will check in along with DJ Russell. Russell will line up actually as the tight end. Mesh, the H-back. They'll also run a wide receiver there as a flanker. On that side, overload the right side. They're going to hand it off. Gage go back to the left side. Glenn Cage across the 45. He's going to be a yard shy of the first down at the 44-yard line of the Crimson Storm. And the Weevils are going to send out some more big tight ends. Now we've got an injury timeout on the field as a player for UAM is shaken up. It'll be fourth down and a long yard for the Bo Weevils. When play resumes, we're going to try to keep it right here. 5:57 left to go here in the first half. Crimson Storm leading 14 to nothing. If you joined us late, Crimson Storm, we were scoreless at the end of the first quarter. Southern Nazarene has scored 14 here in the second period. Going to be one of the big offensive linemen for the Weevils shaking up on the play. He's going to walk off the field, though, under his own power. Looks like Bayless Jones, 320-pound junior. He'll walk off the field under his own power and come over here and take a breather. Weevils looking at fourth down and a long yard. They go with a big package, the tight ends. Direct snap comes back to Arlie Lee. He's straight ahead. He's got the first down as he'll carry it down close to the 42-yard line before he finally pushed backwards. But that'll be a first down for the Bo Weevils. And that'll keep the drive alive. That wasn't Arlie Lee. It was number eight that time. That was Giovanni Gibson on the carry for the Bo Weevils. First and 10, UAM. At the Storm, 41-yard line. Middleton back in at quarterback now. Middleton hands it off to Cage. Cage hit in the backfield, going to be dropped for a loss. As coming through was David Osmigi. Osmigi hit him. Let's see where they mark his forward progress. Going to be at the 43-yard line, so a loss of two on the play. But he was there just about the time Cage got the handoff. Bring up second down and 12 now for UAM. We're under 4:50 left to play here in the first half. 14 to nothing. The Crimson Storm with the lead. They'll go to a three-man front defensively. They'll drop eight back in coverage, it looks like. Now they bring a run blitz. Throw it. Ball thrown. It's a short completion just inside the 40-yard line. We get a little bit of that yardage back. A gain of three on the play. It'll be third down and nine. Pass was complete over there, it looks like, to Giovanni Gibson. So third down and three, or third down and nine, make it. Third down and nine from the 39-yard line. Middleton, straight drop, going deep over the middle for Arlie Lee. This one's in off his shoulder pads, broken up at the last second there. Tavion Houghton got there just about the time the ball did. So it'll fall incomplete and bring up a fourth down for the Bo Weevils. Fourth and nine from the Storm 39-yard line. Trailing 14 to nothing. Looks like the Weevils are going to go for it here on fourth down with 4:04 left to go in the first half. We'll see twin receivers on either side, Mansfield and Jacobs, split wide to the left. And now the Weevils are going to call a timeout to talk about it. We'll take it with them. It's 14 to nothing. The Crimson Storm leading. We're back after this timeout.
Please, the UAM Sports Association is the exclusive private fundraising arm of UAM Athletics. Its mission to raise private funds to support 300 Bull Weevil and Cotton Blossom student-athletes in competition on and off the field. Annual membership starts at $50. Visit UAMSports.com to learn more about the UAM Sports Association. Become a member and invest in UAM Athletics today.
Yeah. 4:04 remaining in the first half. Weevils looking at fourth down and nine. They're going to punt it away as Rosati comes on. We'll try to pin them back deep once again. 14-0 our score. The Crimson Storm have the lead, and there's a flag before the snap. Going to be a false start.
False start. 39. Kicking team. Still fourth down.
So we'll back them up five. Now to give Grisotti a little more room to work with. That'll back it up. Ball will be spotted at the 44-yard line. The return man back there is Flores. He'll be standing at the 10 to get the punt. This one hangs high in the air. Fair catch called for. They'll move away from it. There's a flag, however, that comes in. Two flags come in. I don't think anybody interfered with the return man. As Flores was coming up to make the fair catch, he backed away or looked like he let up before he went to it. Let's see what the call is.
Interference with the opportunity to make a catch. 15-yard penalty for spot of foul. First down.
That's what the call was, so they interfered with him trying to make the fair catch. That'll be a 15-yard penalty against the Boll Weevils. So that's going to put it all the way out close to the 26-yard line. Now the officials are making sure they got it right. Coach Jackson wanting an explanation. So the head white hat guy is going to come over and talk to Coach Jackson here on the sideline and explain to him what the call is. 3:57 to go in the first half. 14-0. Crimson Storm with the lead. Football's going to be marked out at the 26-yard line, first and 10 for the Crimson Storm from their own 26. Gage Porter stays at the quarterback spot. The running back now is Carlos Zapita. And the Weevils are going to go to a four-man front defensively. Alfrini Hankins anchors this right defensive end on this series. Porter takes the snap, hands it off right side. Zapita's out over the 25. He'll be out close to the 30, the 31-yard line before he's finally brought down. Make it the 32. A gain of 6 on the play. Second down and 4 now for the Storm. Twin receivers will come wide to the left. One receiver goes wide right for Southern Nazarene. Zapita stays in at the running back spot. Porter looks over the defense. Put a wide receiver in motion to the wide side. Fake it to him. Porter tripped up in the backfield, and he's going to lose a couple of yards. See if back to the 31-yard line. It'll bring up a third down and a long 4, almost 5. We're under 3 minutes left to play in the first half. Crimson Storm leading 14-0 here this afternoon. Tight ends to the wide side of the field for the Storm. Third and 4. Rolling to his left. Porter looking downfield. Throws deep. This one should be intercepted, and it is. Back at the 40. Returned up to midfield. Up to the 45. Back to the 40. Down the right sideline to the 20, to the 15, the 10, the 5. Knocked out of bounds just inside the 2-yard line. And making the interception is going to be, I believe, Taylor Collins. Taylor Collins on the interception and the return back to the 2-yard line. So big set of return. They say it is a touchdown now. Touchdown for the Weevils. He did go in before he went out of bounds. So 14-6. The pick six by Taylor Collins, the freshman out of Allen, Texas. Grisotti will come on to attempt the extra point. Snaps down, the kick's on its way, and it is good. And it's 14-7. Weevils have some new life with 2:24 to play before halftime. Southern Nazarene leads it. We're back after this timeout.
Southern Nazarene 14, and your UAM Boll Weevils 7.
your attention real quick. The winning ticket is 3997569. Again, it's 3997569.
Taylor Collins with a 59-yard pick six. So the Weevils are on the boards. It's 14-7. Southern Nazarene leads it as the Weevils get set to kick it off toward the south end zone. It's going to be fielded up at the 8. Return to the 10. 15, 20, and hit hard at the 22-yard line. And that's where it'll go down. And that's where the Crimson Storm will have it first and 10. At their own 21-yard line, where they mark it down with 2:16 to play here before halftime. Southern Naz has all three timeouts remaining. They'll spot it at the 21 of Southern Nazarene. I'll make it the 26 of Southern Nazarene. My apologies, the 26-yard line. First and 10 for the Crimson Storm.
He will get you information on your chance to kick a field goal.
Farr will come wide to the left along with Andrew Tisdale. He'll line up as a wide out. Gage Porter, the quarterback. They put Farr in motion. Fake it to him. Porter keeps it himself around the left end. He gets it to the 30. He'll be tripped up there. Coming up nice with an open field tackle for the Weevils. That's going to be Collins again making the play there. So two good plays by the defensive safety for the Weevils. A gain of 5 on the play. It could have been a lot more if Collins hadn't brought him down there. So second down and 5. We go under a minute 50 left to play before half. And again, the Crimson Storm leads it 14-7. Southern Nazarene will get the football to start the second half as they deferred their option to the second half. Porter looks over the defense. The quarterback sends Farr in motion. Going to fake it to him. Play action. Steps up. Throws short. Underneath. It's going to be incomplete as the pass was intended up there at the 40-yard line for Asa Robinson. He's coming up to make the hit on him. By the time the ball got there for the Weevils was Joshua McGarity for UAM. Ball separated. Incomplete. It'll be third down and 5 now for the Crimson Storm with a minute 26 to play before half. On third and 5, Porter puts Farr in motion, hands it off to him on an end around. He'll turn the corner, flags come in, Farr at midfield, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, touchdown. But bring it all back because of the flags back there in the backfield. You can bring it all back. Gerald Farr got his exercise, holding. Holding called against Southern Nazarene to bring it back. Penalty flags down at the 29-yard line. So they'll mark off the penalty against Southern Nazarene. He's going to spot it back at the 21, it looks like. Make it third down and 15. A big break there for the Weevils. A holding call with a minute 12 left to go before halftime. Southern Nazarene leading 14-7. Bring that touchdown back, and they're looking at third down and 15 now from their own 21-yard line. Porter wanting to throw. Pressure coming. He forced out of the pocket. Scrambling around. Going to be hit. Still on his feet. Breaks a tackle. He's out over the 25. Out to the 30. Lowers his shoulder, dives for the first down marker out at the 37-yard line, and he'll have the first down. A flag does come in at the end of the play. But, wow, they had him dead to rights there in the backfield, couldn't hold on. Look at Gage Porter. He's listed at 5'11", 225 pounds as a quarterback. Dead ball penalty against the defense. So add 15 on to it after the end of the run, which is out at the 37-yard line. With 55 seconds to play now, Southern Nazarene's going to have it in UAM territory at the 48-yard line of UAM, and they still have all three timeouts left. Leading 14-7, Southern Nazarene will have the football. First and 10 at the Weevil 48-yard line.
Timeout, Southern Nazarene.
Southern Nazarene has called a timeout. We'll take it with them with 55 seconds to go. We're back after this timeout.
Fans, visit the official online store of UAM Athletics at shopuamsports.com. In addition to official UAM Sports apparel, the store offers bags, backpacks, pins, car decals, license plates, streetwear, official UAM Under Armour gear, and much, much more. Check out shopuamsports.com.
We tack on the penalty for the personal foul after the end of the play, and then mark it at the 48-yard line of UAM. First and 10, Crimson Storm, with 55 seconds left to go before halftime. Southern Nazarene leading 14-7. Gage Porter again out of the shotgun. We will show a four-man front to put the tight end in motion to the short side of the field. Porter wanted to throw. Has time now, looking, going deep down the right sideline. He throws it, and it's going to be caught up at the 18-yard line. Right down on the sideline, making the catch. There is Gerald Farr for the Crimson Storm, and they're in striking distance now at the 18 inside the red zone. Quickly, they'll come up. Hurry up offense, back to the line of scrimmage. 40 seconds and counting. Porter, play action, rolling left, now rolling right. Hankins giving chase. They're going to catch him at the line of scrimmage and bring him down there, and Southern Nazarene is going to have to call a timeout. Alfreen Hankins was giving chase and finally was managed to get Porter down up at the line of scrimmage. So it'll be second down and 10. Southern Nazarene uses their second timeout of the half with 28 seconds left to go here in the first half. And we would like nothing better than to try to keep them out of the end zone. There's 30 seconds left to play. They put up 2 seconds back on the clock. It'll be first, or make it second and 10 from the Weevil 18-yard line for Southern Nazarene here as they lead it 14-7. Southern Nazarene is... offense has put to 14 points on the board. UAM's only points came from a pick six. And the pick six was by Taylor Collins for UAM. All right, here we go. Second down and 10 from the 18 of UAM. Porter in the backfield at quarterback. One to throw, straight drop. Steps up in the pocket now, in trouble. Now throws toward the goal line. It is going to be incomplete. Knocked away there at the last second. Again, coming up making a great defensive play for UAM. This time is going to be Joshua McGarity. He timed his hit just as the ball got there and knocked it loose from the intended receiver, Asa Robinson. That took 7 seconds off the clock. So it's third down and 10 now for the Crimson Storm. They can get a first down just inside the 8-yard line. Clock stopped with the incomplete pass. They still have one timeout remaining. They go to the pistol formation. The lone setback is going to be Aaron Fellows. Porter wanting to throw, looking, has all day. Now throws toward this goal line. It's going to be caught down at the 1. And did he get in? I'm going to say he's out of bounds at the 1-foot line. Making the catch down there is Asa Robinson. Right on the edge of the sideline, right at the goal line. Quickly, they come up to the line of scrimmage. They're going to spike the football. Looks like a lot of movement up front. That should be a penalty. Now a timeout called by UAM before all that movement took place. Weevils didn't have the right personnel and had to call a timeout. It'll be first and goal to go. Ball at the one-yard line with 16 seconds left to go here before halftime. Southern Nazarene leading 14-7 and knocking on the door before half. UAM down to their final timeout. I don't think they had the right personnel out on the field. Well, they were trying to shuffle some folks in and out, and Southern Nazarene had lined up quickly to snap the football. For the Weevil defense, they've regrouped. They're back out, and you look for Porter to keep this one. They're 1 yard away, or just inside the one, as their offense will come back out on the line. Their offensive line averages 315 pounds across that offensive line. It's first and goal to go with 16 seconds left. Southern Nazarene does have one timeout. Porter will go underneath center. Porter going to try to sneak it himself. The pile will go forward and they push it. And yes, he got in for the score. Flag a long ways away from the football. Back in the back from the back judge. After the play had been blown dead. I'm not sure what that's about. But the touchdown will stand. This was a dead ball foul. We'll see what the white hat says.
Leading in the field is a touchdown. After play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 84 of the offense. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
Number 84 for Southern Nazarene. Call for the unsportsmanlike conduct after the touchdown. 20-7, the extra point coming now for Southern Nazarene with 12 seconds remaining. And there's the snap. The kick's on its way, and it is good. 21-7, Southern Nazarene leads it. We'll be back with the final 16 seconds of the first half when we return in just a moment. They mark off the penalty on Southern Nazarene on the kickoff. So they'll kick off from the 20-yard line. UAM not going to have a whole lot of time to work with as they're going to kick it off. It's going to be fielded back at the 20, up over the 25, the 30, 35, 40, down the sideline. It's going to be bumped out of bounds, I believe. They say he's still going down inside the 40. Yeah, they've got him stepping out of bounds at the 49-yard line of the Crimson Storm with 3 seconds remaining on the clock. As on the return for UAM was number 6, that is A.J. Bullock. The Weevils will have 3 seconds to work with here before halftime. 49 yards away, you got to, you know, you can take a chance at a Hail Mary. Trailing 21-7 from the 49-yard line. We'll see if that's what they elect to do. Middleton is the quarterback, Caden Middleton. He'll line up in the shotgun, three-man rush. Middleton looking, going deep down the left sideline. Going to throw it, and it's going to be intercepted out of bounds as time expires. It is 21-7. The Crimson Storm of Southern Nazarene with a lead over our Boll Weevils here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. As both teams head toward the locker room, don't go anywhere. We'll come back with more at halftime for you when we return in just a moment.
Sponsorship of today's game. We say thank you for your continued support of UAM Athletics.
Southern Nazarene, 21-7 make it our score here at the half. Southern Nazarene has the lead over the Boll Weevils. They scored that one touchdown there late with only 12 seconds remaining before halftime before they kicked it off. But, wow, what a different first half of football here for the Boll Weevils as they came out and have showed some signs of spark and defense. Came up with a pick six. That's the only points on the boards for UAM was a pick six. But it's 21-7 here at the half. Both teams have made their way into the locker room. And again, senior day, so been a lot of celebration going on here on senior day for both the cheerleaders and football team. Glad you're with us on this Saturday afternoon. We've got one more regular season game. That'll be next Saturday as we travel over to Magnolia and play Southern Arkansas in the Battle of the Timberlands for that trophy, that traveling trophy. That'll be next Saturday at 2 o'clock kickoff. We'll have the broadcast for you here on KHBM 93.7 FM. We'll take another break, and we'll come back in just a moment and look at some of the stats here in the first half. When we return to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, our score 21-7, Southern Nazarene leads it.
UAM fans, this is the pride of Southeast Arkansas, your 2023 Boll Weevil Marching Band. The Boll Weevil Marching Band is under the direction of the Director of Bands, Dr. Kristen Zelnick, Percussion Professor, Dr. Stephen Busseth, Color Guard Captain, Lauren Norris from Naples, Texas, Assistant Drum Major, Kenaz Bailey, from Memphis, Tennessee, and drum major Anna Stinnett from Dequeen, Arkansas. For more information about the Boll Weevil Marching Band and the Division of Music, please visit uambandi.com. Weevils.com and follow the Division of Music on Facebook and Instagram. And now, the pride of Southeast Arkansas, Bull Weevil Marching Band presents our Band Day show. The music of Metallica. The album Master of Puppets is widely considered to be one of the greatest and most influential metal albums of all time. In 2015, Master of Puppets became the first metal recording to be selected by the Library of Congress for preservation in the National Recording Registry for being culturally, historically, and aesthetically significant. So today, our first tune is Master of Puppets. Now under the direction of Anna Stinnett.
Back here at Conway Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, 21-7, our score here at the half. Southern Nazarene has the lead over the Bull Weevils. Looking at some stats for you here in the first half. First downs, the Crimson Storm with 10, UAM with 8. UAM has rushed the football 18 times for 33 yards. Southern Nazarene 19 for 148. And they're averaging 7, almost 8 yards a carry. The Weevils averaging almost 2 yards per carry. UAM through the air has gone 12 of 18 passing for 119 yards. So UAM ran 36 plays, 152 yards in the first half. Southern Nazarene ran 30 plays for 284 yards as they had 136 yards through the air there in the first half. Third down conversions, UAM was 2 of 8. Southern Nazarene 2 of 5. Penalties here in the first half. Southern Nazarene penalized 3 times for 30 yards. UAM 3 times for 35 yards. So they've held the penalties down here this afternoon. And we go back and look at recap the scoring for you. Southern Nazarene got on the board first with 13:50 to go in the second quarter. It was a 4-yard run. That was a 7-play, 84-yard drive that took 3 minutes and 8 seconds. Didn't take them long to respond either because it forced UAM to a 3-and-out. And it was Gage Porter that time, the quarterback, on a 3-yard run. That was a 3-play, 75-yard drive that took a minute and 46. And just like that, they were up 14-0 with 8:59 to play in the first half. Weevils got on the boards with 2:24 left to play before halftime. As Collins for UAM, that is Taylor Collins, intercepted a pass and returned it 59 yards for the score. Rosati added the kick, and it was 14-7 with 2:24 to play before halftime. Southern Nazarene took the kickoff and got a nice return back up to the 41-yard line. Southern Nazarene put together an 8-play, 59-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 4 seconds off the clock, left 12 seconds before halftime when they scored. The point after attempt was good, and it's 21-7 here at the half. Southern Nazarene leading the UAM Bull Weevils. I'll be back in just a moment looking at individual numbers for you here in the first half when we return to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium after this timeout. Thank you. 21. To 7, our score here at the half. Southern Nazarene with a lead over the Boll Weevils here this afternoon after the first 30 minutes of football. Looking at some individual numbers for you here in the first half. First of all, for UAM, Glenn Cage has carried 10 times for 24 yards. Gary Furman, 2 times for 15. Giovanni Gibson, 1 time for 4. And Artie Lee, 2 times for 3 yards. So the Weevils on the ground. That's total a mass of 119 yards. Nope, back that up. 33 yards rushing on the afternoon. Southern Nazarene, their leading ground gainer is a quarterback. That's Gage Porter. 12 carries for 75 yards. He's been sacked twice this afternoon. Aaron Fellows, 1 carry for 39 yards. Asa Robinson, 1 carry for 18. And Donald May, 1 carry for 12. So the Nazarene rushed 19 times for 150 yards here in the first half. Passing, Gage Porter went 5 of 10 with one interception, 123 yards and 2 touchdowns. The longest was a 71-yard touchdown strike for Southern Nazarene. Jarvis Davis went 1 of 1 for 13 yards. For UAM, Austin Wadsworth got the start this afternoon. He went 7 of 10 for 76 yards. Got sacked twice on the afternoon. Longest was a 24-yard strike over the middle to Arlie Lee. And then Caden Middleton came in. He went 5 of 8 for 43 yards here in the first half. The longest was a 16-yard pass. 12 of 18 passing for the Weevils. And 119 yards through the air. So 36 plays, 152 total yards of offense. Leading tackler this afternoon for the Boll Weevils, it looks like it's going to be Alfreni Hankins. He's got 3 tackles, 2 of them for loss. And also Demarius White, 3 tackles and 2 for a loss as well. For Southern Nazarene, they've got Carter Brock. He's a big defensive linebacker. He's got 3 total tackles, 1 for a loss this afternoon, leading the way as the Weevils trail here at halftime, 21-7. We've got a combination band out there. They've got the UAM marching band, and then some of the high schools of the area have showed up. I see some Monticello uniform band out there, some Hamburg, it looks like, maybe a couple of other schools as well. We're going to go down and on the field and see if we can pick up a little of the band music that they got going on. And you think about football teams, they have to recruit players to come in and play. The band does as well. That's the reason I've got some of these high school students here marching at halftime and playing with the UAM band. We're at halftime. It is 21-7. The Weevils trails Southern Nazarene. We'll be back with more here at halftime when we return after this timeout. 21-7, our score here at the half. The Weevils trail Southern Nazarene. Final home game of the regular season for the Weevils here today. They'll be on the road next Saturday as we take on Southern Arkansas there in Magnolia. It'll be the Battle of the Timberlands next Saturday. A 2 o'clock kickoff. Our broadcast begins at 1:30 with a pregame show. 2 o'clock the kickoff there from Southern Arkansas in Magnolia. So I hope you'll make plans to join us for that. I know it'll be the opening day of modern gun deer season, but middle of the day, you might want to come out and watch the ball game with us as well. If you can't make it, we'll of course keep it right here to KHBM 93.7 FM. Recap the scoring for you there in the first half. Southern Nazarene got on the board first with 13:50 to play in the second quarter. It was a 7-play, 84-yard drive. Took them 3 minutes and 8 seconds to go down the field. And Davis was able to put it in from 4 yards out. Southern Nazarene led 7-0. Next possession by Southern Nazarene as the Weevils went 3 and out and had to punt it away. Pinned them back at the 25-yard line. They had a big play there. 3 plays, 75 yards. One of them was a 71-yard pass completion. They got him down inside the 5. Gage Porter finished off the drive with a 3-yard run. Took him a minute and 46 to complete that drive. And just like that, they were up 14-0 with 8:59 to play in the second period. UAM got on the boards with 2:24 left to play in the first half. A 59-yard pick 6, an interception by Taylor Collins, a freshman for the Weevils. So they're playing safety this afternoon. And Weevils right back in it, you thought. It was 14-7. Weevils kick off Southern Nazarene, pin them back. They get a pretty good return up to the 41-yard line. And with only 2:24 to play before half, they put together a 59-yard drive. 8 plays, took 2 minutes and 4 seconds off the clock, and they go in at halftime leading 21-7, and that's where we stand right now. Both teams are starting to make their way back out of the dressing room, back out onto the field. Our score 21-7 here at the half. We'll have the third quarter starting up when we return to Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium after these words from our sponsors.
Take care. Sorry.
As we get set to start the third quarter, Southern Nazarene will get the football to start the second half. They won the opening toss and deferred to the second half. Rosati will tee it up and get set to kick it off for UAM. Going back deep is Donald May on one side. UAM going to squib kick it. It's caught up at near midfield and returned to the Weevil 48-yard line. So Southern Nazarene will have an excellent field position to start the third quarter, is making the catch there, and returning it was Alan Hernandez. He caught it at the Storm 48, returned it to the UAM 48, a four-yard return. As we'll see Gage Porter stay in at quarterback for Southern Nazarene. The running back this series for them will be Colby Branch. Nope, he's going to come as a wide receiver. It'll be number six. That's going to be Carlos Zapita at the tailback spot. Porter looks over the defense. Weevils in a four-man front. They're going to hand it off to Farr on an end around. He turns the corner across the 40, inside the 40, down to the 37, make it the 38-yard line before he's finally knocked down there. That's going to be good for 12 yards and a first down. As they'll mark it at the 37-yard line, first and 10. For the Savage Storm on their first play. They pick up 12 yards and a first down. They'll stay with twin receivers, wide left. One goes wide right, tight end to the wide side of the field as well. Ball on the right hash mark, and Southern Nazarene moving from right to left. Porter keeps it himself. The quarterback straight ahead, gets across the 35, down to the 31 of UAM. That'll be a gain of six on the play. They bring up a second down and four now for the Savage Storm. Just underway to start the third quarter, 21-7. Southern Nazarene with the lead and the football. They'll have it second and four from the Weevil 31-yard line. Weevils up front, staying a four-man front defensively. Porter puts a wide receiver in motion, fake it to him, keeps it himself. Porter, big running back. He comes across and gets the first down and more as he'll carry it down inside the 25 to the 24-yard line of UAM. As it looks like Demarius White making the stop for the Boll Weevils. First and 10, though, for Southern Nazarene at the Weevil 24-yard line. Keeping it all on the ground here in the third quarter so far on this opening drive. But, you know, when your offensive line averages about 315 pounds across the line, you can establish the run game. On first and 10, Porter calling for it. Porter hands it off to his back on around the right side. He's at the 20 to the 15, the 10, the 5. A flag's going to come in as he'll be bumped out of bounds inside the 5 down at the 2-yard line. But there is a flag back up at the 15-yard line. And it's going to go against Southern Nazarene. Penalties have been under control this afternoon. This is going to be the fourth penalty against Southern Nazarene on the day. UAM penalized three times here on the day. Holding the call.
Holding, number 27, on offense, a 10-yard penalty. It's still first down.
Holding the call against Southern Nazarene. They'll mark it back to the 24-yard line. So it'll be, let's see where they marked the football. They hadn't marked it yet. Yes, they have. They marked it back at the 24. It'll remain first down. It'll be first and 10. Is that flag thrown up near where the first down marker was? So first and 10. For Southern Nazarene from the Weevil 24. Porter looking to throw, fires again, complete to the tight end at the 10-yard line. He'll carry and be knocked down at the 9-yard line. Coming up to make the stop, Michael McCorvey for UAM, the defensive back. They hit that play in the first half, same play, for a big gain down the field to the tight end, number 84, who is Daylon Smith. He's 6'3", 235 pounds. First and goal to goal at the 9 for Southern Nazarene. Jarvis Davis will check in at the quarterback spot now. Davis gets the snap, going to leave it. Or he keeps it himself. Ball comes loose. It's on the ground. There's a scramble for it. The Weevils say they have it. Down at the 6-yard line and coming up out of there with it for UAM on the fumble recovery is going to be Keith Wells Jr. The 250-pound freshman from right here in Monticello recovers the fumble as the quarterback, Davis that time, got hit as he crossed the line of scrimmage. Ball came loose and Wells was there to recover. Weevils get the break, 21-7 our score. And the Weevils get the ball back down at their own 6-yard line. First and 10. The quarterback, they're going to stay with Middleton here to start the third period. Middleton takes the snap, going to hand it off to Cage. Cage out over the 10, out to the 15, still on his feet at the 20, dragging bodies with him to the 21-yard line. Glenn Cage on the carry for the Boll Weevils. Move the chains, that'll be a first down. Big run there of out to the 21-yard line, a 15-yard pickup. Quarterback Middleton, this time hands off again to Gaze. He's hot behind the line of scrimmage. He's going to lose a yard back at the 20. So it'll be second down and 11 now for UAM from their own 20-yard line. Weevils moving from left to right here in the third quarter. Little or no wind blowing this afternoon here at Convoy Leslie. That hadn't been a factor. But Weevils going into the sunlight, which is setting in the southwest. Middleton takes the snap, handoff again to Cage, breaks it outside. A flag comes in as Gaze loses his helmet across the 21 out to the 22-yard line. A tough couple of yards there for Cage, but we'll see what the flags are all about. And doesn't look good for the Weevils. Cage lost his helmet. It got knocked off. Maybe a flag against Southern Nazarene. Let's see.
Face mask, number 10 of the defense. 15 yards. First down.
So it is a penalty against Southern Nazarene, a personal foul face mask. So we have a UAM another first down, and hey, they're on the move. Even with the penalty, that's going to mark the football out close to the 38-yard line. We'll take it. Trailing 21-7, Weevils need a break or two here in this second half. Twin receivers go wide left. Twins come wide right. Caden Middleton, the quarterback for the Weevils, out of the shotgun. Blitz coming from the outside. He unloads it down the field for Arlie Lee. Makes a one-handed catch at the 48 of Southern Nazarene and is bumped out of bounds. Nice grab by Arlie Lee. Arlie is a freshman out of Stuttgart, Arkansas. Makes the catch over there for the Boll Weevils. We're in Crimson Storm territory at the 47-yard line. First and 10 Weevils. Middleton again out of the shotgun. Cage, the lone setback beside him on the right side. Wanting to throw, now forced out of the pocket. Middleton's going to be caught and going to be dropped behind the line of scrimmage back at the 49. It's going to be a loss of 2 on the play. Pocket collapsed. Cage couldn't get out of it. Or make it Middleton couldn't get out of it. Second down and 12 now for the Weevils. 9:24 to play, third quarter, 21-7. Southern Nazarene has the lead on second and long. A lot of movement, a lot of pointing. Flags come in, and we're going to have a false start on the offense.
Number 66 of the offense, 5 yards.
A false start on the offensive line. They tab it on Ryan Williams, the offensive lineman. It'll be second down and 16 now for the Boll Weevils. They'll spot the football back at the UAM 46-yard line. Need to get down to the 37 for a first down to the Southern Nazarene 37. Ian Mesh checks in at the tight end H-back spot. Twin receivers come wide right. One goes wide left now. Middleton Straight drop back. Blitz coming from the outside. He unloads it down the left sideline for Mansfield, and it's off his fingertips. He was bobbling it as he went down. Thought he could grab it in, but couldn't hold on. Straight fly pattern down the left sideline. And Mansfield just couldn't haul it in, just off his fingertips. That'll bring up third and long now for UAM. Caleb Jacobs checks back into the ball game. Ian Mash will come out. We'll have Arlie Lee split wide right with Javonte Gibson. Mansfield and Jacobs go wide to the left. Third down and 16. They'll rush three this time. Middleton looking. Finally fires into a crowd. It's going to be caught down the field. Down to the 36-yard line of Southern Nazarene and making the grab, Javonte Gibson. And that'll be right at the first down. Yes, he does have the first down by a yard. So move the chains, a big third down, a gain of 17 on the play. And UAM keeps the drive alive with 8:30 to play in the third. Hurry up offense back. Middleton wanting to throw again. Going deep into triple coverage. Overthrows everybody. Flags are going to come in. We're going to get defensive pass interference. As the pass was intended for Arlie Lee, he was wanting the flag thrown before the ball went over his head. But they'll call the flag against Southern Nazarene now.
Interference, number 19 of the defense. 15 yards from previous spot. Includes an automatic first down.
So two big penalties here on this drive. Keeps it alive for the Weevils. They'll have it first and 10. They're going to spot the football down at the 21-yard line of Southern Nazarene. Deepest UAM has been inside Crimson Storm territory this afternoon. First and 10 from the 21, trailing by 14, 21-7 our score. Glenn Cage, the running back. Caden Middleton, the freshman quarterback out there, takes the snap, straight drop, steps up in the pocket, goes to the end zone, going to be overthrown again. Intended for Arlie Lee down there in the back of the end zone. But he had double coverage on him as well. So that'll bring up second down and 10. Now Mesh will check back in as the tight end spot. Ian Mesh, Caleb Jacobs will come out. As the Weevils look into Coach Qualls for the play, the offensive coordinator here for UAM. 15 on the play clock. He gets the play called in. Mesh will line up on the right side. That's the wide side of the field with twin receivers out there as well. On second and 10, going to hand it off to Cage. Cage hit in the backfield and going to be dropped for a loss back at the 23-yard line. Coming through for Southern Naz was Nick Blanchard, the defensive end. He came untouched. Going to be a loss of one on the play. It'll be third down and 11. On the afternoon, the Weevils are 3 of 9 on third down conversions. Down to 7:45 and counting. Left to play in the third quarter. Southern Nazarene leading 21-7. Weevils in four down territory here. Can't settle for a field goal, I don't think. Middleton wanting to throw. Steps up in the pocket over the middle. Ball is tipped in the air. Going to be intercepted in the end zone by Southern Nazarene. And he'll just take a knee and take the touchback. As coming up with a tip ball was Ethan Miner. Pass was intended for Arlie Lee, it looked like, and the ball got tipped in the air, and Southern Nazarene comes down with it in the end zone. So both teams with a turnover deep in the other's territory. Southern Nazarene will have it first and 10 at their own 20 when play resumes. A timeout on the field, 7:25 to play third quarter, 21-7 our score. We're back in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to take this opportunity, if we could direct your attention to the pond side of the field directly below the scoreboard. We'd like to say thank you and a great appreciation to Mr. Kenny Hodges. Mr. Kenny has set his retirement date, and we, as a members of the UAM community, would like to say thank you for 30 years of service to UAM. Let's give a big round of applause, Mr. Kenny Hodges.
We 21-7, Southern Nazarene leads it. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 20 following the interception in the end zone. Both teams have a turnover here in the second half. Weevils took over at their own 6, turn it over on in the end zone. So here we go. First down, Southern Naz, a handoff on an end around, out over the 25, out to the 30, 35, 40, out to the 45, finally hung around him down at midfield as the ball carrier that time was Donald May. That'll be good for 30 yards and a big first down for Southern Nazarene all the way out to midfield. 7:04 to play in the quarter, third quarter. Southern Nazarene now with 186 yards on the ground. First and 10, Gage Porter, your quarterback for Southern Nazarene. Puts a flanker in motion to the wide side, wanting to throw. Quick pass. This one's almost intercepted. It was overthrown. And diving, trying to make the interception for UAM, a little disgusted with himself. There's a free safety back there for UAM. He's already had one interception this afternoon, Taylor Collins. Second down and 10 now for Southern Nazarene. The running back is going to be Carlos Zapita. He'll check into the ball game at running back for the Crimson Storm. They'll send twin receivers wide right, ball on the left hash mark. One receiver comes wide left. That's Joa Flores. Porter looks over the defense. Weevil stay in a four-man front. They put a man in motion, hand it off. Zapita across midfield is going to get it down to the Weevil 46-yard line, make it the 45-yard line. That'll be a gain of almost 5 on the play, and we've got an injured Weevil slow in getting up out there as the trainers will go out, and Shelley's going to go check on him. 6:26 to play here in the third quarter. It's 21-7. Southern Nazarene has the lead over the Bull Weevils. Again, we've got an injured Weevil down on the field as the trainers and Coach Jackson go out there to check on him. Don't forget, next Saturday we travel to Southern Arkansas in Magnolia. 2 o'clock kickoff. We'll start our pregame at 1:30. Kickoff will be at 2 p.m. for the Battle of the Timberlands. And we'll have the broadcast right here on KHBM 93.7 FM. They got the injured player up, and he's going to walk off the field. It looks like Michael Pope gingerly walking, favoring his left leg. It'll be third down and 5 for Southern Nazarene, a short 5. Almost 4. Third down, they need to get just shy of the 40-yard line for the first down. The ball is spotted just shy of the 45. So we'll call it third and 5 for Southern Nazarene. Checking in for Pope is going to be Robert Iverson, that linebacker. All right, we're ready for play to resume. Gage Pope, the quarterback for the Storm, puts a wide receiver in motion, fakes it to him, keeps it himself. Porter breaks one tackle, gets it inside the 45, down close to the 41-yard line. Going to be about a yard shy of the first down. It'll bring up a third and short now for Southern Nazarene. Third down and 1 from the 41. They'll quickly come back up, go with two tight ends, two H-backs. Porter underneath motion and a lot of contact, finger pointing. Southern Nazarene saying UAM jumped off sides. We'll let the officials sort it out if they were drawn off sides or if they actually got into the neutral zone and made contact. So let's see. Offsides.
Number 98 of the defense made contact. 5 yards results in a first down.
They'll tab Keith Wells Jr. with being offsides and making contact, so it'll be a first down, a 5-yard penalty. Mark it down to the 36-yard line of UAM. First and 10, Southern Nazarene. First and 10 from the Weevil, 36. Porter again puts a wide receiver in motion to the right. Porter wanting to throw, fires over the middle to his tight end. This time it's a little too hard. Probably had the sun in his eyes as the intended receiver there. Once again was Dalen Smith. He's a tight end. He's got two receptions already this afternoon. He was open again, but looking right back into the sun, and that might have caused him to not see it clearly. That'll bring up second down and 10. So second down and 10 from the 36 of UAM. Carlos Cepeda lines up on the left side of Gage Porter, the quarterback. Trip receivers go wide right. Porter's going to keep it himself straight ahead. He's across the 35. He'll carry down close to the 33-yard line. It'll be a gain of 3 on the play. And the Storm will be looking at third down and 7. From the 33-yard line of UAM. So the Nazarene doing a lot of looking into the sideline, taking a lot of time off the clock with a 14-point lead, 21-7. They're going to go empty backfield, it looks like. No, they put a wide receiver in at running back this time. It's going to be Donald May. He'll line up in the pistol formation behind Porter. Now they put him in motion. Empty backfield and four wide. Flags come in before the snap. This one may be an offsides against Southern Nazarene. It'll be a false start.
False start. Number 75 in the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
So instead of third and 7, it's going to be third down and 12 now for Southern Nazarene as they'll spot the football back somewhere around the 43-yard line. Oh, they make it to 38-yard line. It was at the 33. So third down and 12. Weevils will rush 4. Porter steps up, forced out of the pocket, running to his right. Now throws a pass. It's going to be caught inside the 25 and bumped out of bounds. Down near the 18, 17-yard line. As making the catch over there for Southern Nazarene is Braxton Bird, his first reception of the afternoon. But there's another example of a third and long, and the Weevil defense can't get him off the field. It was a third and 12. They ended up getting it down to the 18-yard line. So a 15-yard reception. It'll be first and 10, Southern Nazarene in the red zone. They mark it at the 17-yard line, first and 10. They go with two backs in the backfield, an offset eye out of the shotgun. Hand it to the big tight end, the fullback that time. He goes straight ahead inside the 15, has his feet cut out from under him at the 10-yard line. As coming up to make the stop on him was McCorvey. He lost his helmet in the process of making that tackle. It'll be a gain of 8 on the play and bring up a second down and 2 now for Southern Naz inside the 10 at the 9-yard line. We're down to 3:47 left to play in the third quarter. Southern Nazarene leading 21-7. Both teams have had a turnover here in the third quarter, so really neither defense stopped the other offense. They stopped themselves. It was a fumble recovery down here deep in Weevil territory, the last possession by Southern Nazarene. Weevil's needing that to happen again. Porter, straight drop, a delayed draw. He's ahead inside the 5. He's into the end zone. Touchdown. Gage Porter, the quarterback for Southern Nazarene, did a little drop back and a delayed draw. And he'll go in from 9 yards out and puts the Storm up 27-7 here with 3:16 left to play in the third quarter. Their kicker, Adam Atwell, will come on to attempt the extra point. He's been perfect on today, 3 of 3. Right-footed soccer-style kicker as he gets set. Snaps down, the kick's on away, and it's blocked and picked up over there. That's Hooks. Greg Hooks on the return gets tackled out at the 15-yard line. So the extra point will be no good as it got blocked up front.
This one is no good.
And it is 27-7, our score, with a timeout on the field, 3:16 to play in the third period. Southern Nazarene leads it. We're back after this timeout. Thank you. 27-7, Southern Nazarene takes advantage of the turnover. They go 80 yards in 11 plays. It makes it 27-7. The extra point was no good as it was missed. Caleb Jacobs will go back deep on one side for the Weevils. Also going back deep on the near side to us is Trey Carter. Southern Nazarene gets set to kick it off. 3:16 to play in the third period. Their kicker gets set to kick it off. This is Cameron Van Pruen. He'll handle the kickoff duties. High end-over-end kick. Caleb Jacobs is going to field it at the 12. Up over the 15 to the 20. 25 gets it all the way back out to the 30-yard line. And UAM will start first and 10 from the 30-yard line. An 18-yard return on the kickoff. And Weevil offense got some work to do with 3:03 to play in the third, trailing by three scores. Going to have to get something going. Caden Middleton came in midway through the first period and relieved the quarterback, Wadsworth. Done a pretty good job since he came in. This series, Gary Furman's in at the running back spot on first and 10. Middleton wanting to throw, looking to the sideline. Throws, this one's complete out over the 40, the 45, and up to the 48-yard line is making the catch out there is Giovanni Gibson. Gibson with a nice catch and run. That'll move the chain. A gain of 18 on the play, make it 19 as they mark it at the 49-yard line of UAM. First and 10. Weevil stay in the spread. Twins on either side. Middleton, straight drop again. Steps up, dumps it off to Furman out of the backfield. He's across midfield, lowers his shoulder at the 45. He'll get it down to about the 44-yard line. But Furman made the defensive back that came up to make the stop on him pay for that one. He lowered his shoulder, and his momentum carried him forward for another yard. A gain of 7 on the play. It'll be second down and 3. Weevils in the hurry-up offense. Snap the football. Middleton throwing again to the sideline. This one's complete. That's going to be Gibson again. Giovanni, nope, that's going to be Mansfield with the catch this time. He gets the first down as he'll be down close to the 36-yard line. First and 10, Weevils. Ball's on the right hash mark. He threw it all the way to the left sideline. So a long throw by Middleton. Again, looking to throw. Fires quick over the middle. This one's complete to Arnie Lee. Breaks a tackle at the 25 to the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Arnie Lee for the Weevils. The freshman from Stuttgart with the catch and the run, and the Weevils are down by 14 now with the extra point team coming onto the field. 27-13, a minute 32 to go in the third quarter. Grisotti will attempt the extra point out of the hold of Caleb Jacobs. Everyone gets set. Weevils kicking into that south end zone. The snap's down, kicks on its way. Grisotti puts it through the end zone, through the uprights. 27-14, our score. Weevils down by 13 at the moment with a minute 32 to play in the third. We're back after this timeout.
Fans, UAM is in the process of promoting the Legacy Campaign. The Legacy Campaign is focused on enhancing the support of student-athletes through major facility improvements. Please help support our student-athletes with this major facility improvement and upgrade. For more information on the Legacy Campaign and how to donate, please contact UAM Athletics for more information.
27-14, the Weevils on the board and kick it off. This one goes toward the sideline. It's going to go out of bounds. It's Rosati. Got too much of a leg into that one toward the sideline, and Southern Nazarene is going to get it out at the 35-yard line. It'll be first and 10 there. As the Weevils put together, let's see, that was a 69-yard drive. Took them seven plays to go the distance, and all of it but one was through the air. So Southern Nazarene will have it first and 10 at their own 35-yard line. A minute 32 to go here before the end of the third period. 27-14 our score. Both teams have scored once in the third period. Gage Porter stays in at the quarterback spot. He'll line up in the shotgun, one back beside him. Puts Fur in motion, going to fake it to him. Porter straight ahead. Boy, he's a 225-pound quarterback. Runs over the 40. Ball came loose. They say it was caused by the ground. Weevils had recovered it. Out at the 42-yard line where Porter went down as he hit the turf, or hit the grass, the ball came out. So it'll be a gain of 7 on the play. Second down and 3 now for Southern Nazarene. They'll send twin receivers wide left. Porter in the backfield has Carlos Cepeda as running back this time. Now a timeout call. Down on the field. I believe UAM's going to call the timeout.
There's a challenge on the last play.
So I see. Yep. We'll take it with them. 27-14 our score. 49 seconds remain in the third. As Coach Jackson wanted an explanation on why that wasn't a fumble. Let's keep it right here. He wanted an explanation of why it wasn't a fumble. UAM's going to challenge it. All right, that's it. So they're going to have to go over to the far sideline and look at the replay. UAM gets a challenge, and if they win it, they don't lose the timeout. If they lose the challenge, they'll lose the timeout, and everything will stay the same. But it's worth challenging. If that ball came out before he went down to the ground, UAM did recover it. So let's take a break. We'll come back while they look at the challenge. 27-14 our score, so the Nazarene leads it. We're back after this. Southern Nazarene with the lead. UAM has challenged the ruling on the field that the ground caused the fumble. And officials are over there at the tent looking at the replay to see if they can determine with undisputable evidence that it was a fumble or if he was down by contact on the ground. So we're waiting for them to do that. While they do that, we'll remind you that we're on the road next Saturday. We travel for the final game of the regular season as we travel to Southern Arkansas University. They're in Magnolia. 1:30 with our pregame show next week. 2 o'clock with the kickoff right here on KHBM, 93.7 FM. And we need to send a congratulations out to some of the high school, area high school teams for making the 4A state playoffs. Monticello defeated Crossett on Thursday night to capture the number 3 seed out of the 8-4A going into the state tournament. They travel all the way to Highland, which is up west east of Jonesboro, next Friday night for the first round action. McGee also one against West Helena. They captured the number 5 seed out of the 8-4A. Warren has the number 1 seed. They'll be at home next Friday night against Truman. And then DeWitt, the number 2 seed's at home. Crossett, the number 4 seed, is on the road, I think, to Nashville next Friday night. Well, the ruling on the field is going to stand. It was not a fumble, so Southern Nazarene will maintain possession of the football. It'll be second down and 3 from their own 42-yard line with 49 seconds to go here in the third quarter. All the officials get set back where they're supposed to be, and we're ready for action again. Gage Porter, the quarterback for Southern Nazarene. Carlos Zepeda, the running back. On second down and 3. Weevil showing the outside blitz. They're going to hand it off to Zepeda straight ahead. Zepeda trying to second effort. He's going to be stopped short of the first down. He's going to be stopped at the 44-yard line. Needed to get to the 45. So it's going to bring up a third down and 1. Third down and 1 for Southern Nazarene from their own 44-yard line. They'll come back to the line of scrimmage. Only 21 seconds remain here in the third quarter. Thought they might not snap the football, but it looks like they're going to. Porter's going to keep it himself. Porter hit at the line. He'll have the first down, as I think they're going to mark his forward progress just beyond the 45-yard line. He didn't get it by much, but just enough. As time expires here at the end of the third quarter, our score 27-14. Southern Nazarene will have it first and 10 from their own 46-yard line when play resumes for the final 15 minutes of this one here from Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium when we return after this timeout.
I'd like to direct your attention to the far side. We have Nicholas Rosas from Elaine, Spain. She's a member of our golf team and is going to be attempting to kick a field goal. And in order to win a gift certificate. So everybody, let's make her a big round of applause. You look good from up here.
Twenty-seven to 14 as we get set to start the final 15 minutes of this one here this afternoon. Southern Nazarene has the lead and the football, first and 10 at their own 46-yard line. Southern Nazarene, 48 plays, 428 yards on the afternoon. UAM has run 50 offensive plays for 270 yards. Southern Nazarene, Porter is going to keep it himself around the left end. He's across midfield, the 45, down to the 40, and finally bumped out of bounds, now near the 35-yard line of UAM. They'll move the chains, and that'll be a first down, down at the UAM 35-yard line. See if I can get you the individual numbers on Porter. He's 7 of 14 passing for 131 yards. Need to get his rushing yards. Here we go. 20 carries, 111 yards on the afternoon for him. Throws a pass complete to the tight end at the 20, to the 15, to the 5. Going to be down close to the end zone. He is in for the touchdown. Wow. Number 84, Dalen Smith. It's almost like a shuttle pass as Porter starts to take off running toward the line of scrimmage and just pushes it to the tight end. By then, the linebackers have already committed to the run, and he has been wide open this afternoon. And that will extend the lead 33-14 now with the extra point coming from Southern Nazarene. Weevils blocked the last extra point. There's a push up front, but this one's going to go through the uprights and good. 34-14, Southern Nazarene leads it. 14-16 left to play here in the fourth quarter. We'll be back after this timeout.
Fans, at this time, we'd like to recognize our partners who make a solid impact on UAM Athletics, our game day sponsors, BASF and Mid-South Sea. We'd also like to thank Ag Up and our corporate sponsors, Showcase of Floors, South Arkansas Rehab, Martins, Citizen Bank, Domino's Pizza, Clark Contractors, Commercial Bank, Interfloor, Drew County Farm Bureau, Ryburn Automotive, Paul Griffin Shelter Insurance, Paradigm Fitness, Sea Ark Eye Care, Hampton Inn, Holiday Inn, Quality Inn, Jefferson Regional Medical Center, and Mainline Health Systems. As well as recognizing
34-14. So the Nazarene extends it back out to a three-score lead here this afternoon as they missed one extra point. So the Weevils trail it 34-14. And, again, you go back and look at the individual stats. Gage Porter, he's been their offense. 170 yards through the air that he's responsible for, 8 of 15, one interception and one touchdown. Then on the ground, he's carried 20 times for 130 yards on the ground. So he's got almost 300 yards to his credit. So the Nazarene gets set to kick it off. Their kicker, Cameron Van Poren, will kick it off deep. This one going to be in the air and fielded by Caleb Jacobs at the 8. Return to the 10. There's a flag as it'll come out of the 15-yard line or maybe at the end of the play. They may wave it off. Nope, they're going to throw the flag down up at the 20-yard line. That's where Jacobs went down. But see what the call is going to be. Came from the white hat all the way back at the goal line. They're discussing what they're going to do. 34-14 our score. 14-12 left to play here in the ball game. And I'm thinking they may have thought that Caleb Jacobs called for a fair catch and then took off running after he caught the football. But I really didn't see that. The officials are still conferring down there at the 20-yard line to see what they're going to do. Maybe we can get an explanation.
Illegal wedge formation by receiving team. They would be half the distance to go from the end of the spot of foul. First down.
Well, there's the explanation. I didn't understand what he said, but there's going to be half the distance to the goal against UAM. Penalty-wise, this afternoon, that'll be the sixth penalty for 55 yards against the Weevils. So the Nazarene's been penalized 7 times for 75 yards on the afternoon. And still Coach Jackson is saying he's trying to get an explanation. The white hat's going to come over and talk to him. I didn't understand the call. It was an illegal formation, I think, is what he tabbed on the receiving team. Coach Jackson is pleading his case. He's going to turn around, and you can tell he's not very happy. They'll mark it back to the 10-yard line. Weevils will have it first and 10 at their own 10-yard line. Trailing by 20 points, 34-14. Middleton, who came in midway through the first quarter at quarterback, he replaced Wadsworth, who got to start this afternoon. He's going to hand it off to Cage. Glenn Cage breaks a tackle. He's at the 10. He's running sideways, though, laterally across the field, only going to get it out to about the 12-yard line. Maybe a gain of 2 on the play by Glenn Cage. A lot of running just to get 2 yards. It'll be second down and 8 now for the Boll Weevils from their own 12-yard line. 13:50 left to play in the ball game. 34-14, Southern Nazarene with the lead. Middleton again, calling for the signal snap. Wants it, wants to throw. He fires. It's going to be through the hands of his intended receiver out there, Giovanni Gibson. Giovanni's had a good afternoon, but couldn't hold on to that one. As the Weevils will look at third down and 8 from their own 12-yard line. So an obvious passing down. Southern Naz is going to rush 3. They'll drop 8 back in coverage. Middleton throws. It's high. It's off the fingertips of Gibson, and this one goes incomplete as it's tipped in the air. But that was Arlie Lee. I'm sorry. Arlie Lee was the intended receiver. So UAM's going to be forced to punt for the 5th time this afternoon. It'll be the first punt of the second half by either team. Weevils 4 punts on the day, averaging 29 yards. Rosati's going to be kicking from about 3 yards deep in his own end zone when he gets the snap. So the Nazarene has one man back at midfield. That's Flores, the return man, standing at midfield. Rosati gets a good snap, a high booming kick. Fair catch called for by Flores out at the 50-yard line. So that'll go down as a 38-yard punt. And Southern Nazarene will get the football, first and 10 at midfield, here with 13:03 to play in the fourth quarter. There is a flag, however, on that punt. Holding against Southern Nazarene. They'll spot that or mark it off after the end of the play. So it's going to mark them back to the 40-yard line, their own 40, to start this drive instead of starting at midfield. There's a hold called on the return team. They'll start first and 10 from their own 40-yard line. The official spots the football. Glenn Cage. Nope, we're going to have a new quarterback. That's Jarvis Davis in at the quarterback now for Southern Nazarene. Davis takes the snap. Going to hand it off on the end around. Out over the 45, out near the 49-yard line. Coming up to make the stop for the Boll Weevils is Taylor Collins. On the carry with Donald May. It'll be good for 9 yards and bring up a second down and 1 for the Savage Storm. Or Crimson Storm, make it, I'm sorry. The Crimson Storm. Second down and 1. The clock continues to run. We go under 12 minutes and 35 seconds left to play in the ballgame. So Jarvis Davis is going to get probably the remaining duties at quarterback for Southern Nazarene. Gage Porter, they'll save him, and he's had a workhorse this afternoon. Davis fakes the handoff, keeps it himself. He's got the first down as he goes into Boll Weevil territory, down to the 48-yard line. A gain of 3 on the play. That'll move the chains. It'll be a first down. They mark it at the 49, so a gain of only 2. Second down and 10 now for Southern Nazarene. Looking at Porter's individual numbers there again for you. He was 8 of 15, had one touchdown, one interception for 170 yards passing. He carried the ball 20 times for 130 yards on the ground. And 3 touchdowns this afternoon. Here's the end around again. Handed off by the Crimson Storm. Weevil stretch it out. They'll do good to get it back to the line of scrimmage. It's on the carry that time for Southern Nazarene. It's going to be Joel Flores. Coming up to make the stop for the Boll Weevils was Demarion Holmes. Holmes, one of the seniors on this squad, I believe. Yes. Out of Waco, Texas. No gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10 for the Crimson Storm with 11 minutes left to play here in the contest. And Southern Nazarene taking a lot of time. Play clock down to 10 as they come to the line of scrimmage. Davis working out of the shotgun. Play clock down to 1. They snap the football. He'll hand it off to his halfback. He's over the right side, and he'll get a yard. And that's about all. He's on the carry that time for Southern Nazarene. He's going to be Arlen Welch. He'll get a yard. He'll bring up second down and 9. Now spotted at the Weevil 48-yard line. Like I said, Southern Nazarene wanting the clock to run. They're going to run the play clock down. Again, we go under 10:15 left to play here in the fourth quarter. It is third down and 9. It's third and 9 for Southern Nazarene. Davis out of the shotgun. Weevils will rush 4, it looks like. They'll drop 7 back in coverage. Pressure coming. Davis gets away from it. He's going to be hit. Breaks the tackle. Runs left side across the 45. Flags will come in at the end of the play as he's knocked down at the 45. Make it the 46-yard line of UAL. But there are flags everywhere. There's 3 flags came out simultaneously over there. It's got to be a hold or an illegal block against Southern Nazarene. We'll wait and see. Figure it out. Personal foul. Blindside block called against Southern Nazarene. Wow. Personal foul, 15-yard penalty. Going to mark them all the way back, deep back in their own territory. Ball was at the 47 of UAM. They'll mark it back to the 37 of Southern Nazarene. So a 15-yard penalty. It'll remain third down. It's going to be third and 23 now for Southern Nazarene. So a third and long here with 9:36 to go in the game. Southern Nazarene leading 34-14. The backup quarterback, Jarvis Davis, takes the snap, wanting to throw. Looking. Forced out of the pocket. Throws it down the field, and it's going to be incomplete, overthrown. Taylor Collins defending on the play intended for Joa Flores. And the Weevils are going to force Southern Nazarene to punt for the first time here in the second half. It will be only their second punt of the afternoon. Back deep is going to be Caleb Jacobs to return for the Bow Weevils. The punter is Cameron Van Perwen. And Perwen gets a high snap, pulls it down. Weevils came after it. He gets it off. And a nice punt. Jacobs going to field it at the 20 and bobbles it and then falls on it at the 20-yard line. So the Weevils will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. A 41-yard punt by Van Perwen. And the Weevil offense will come out with 9:12 left to go in the contest. 34-14, our score. Southern Nazarene has the lead here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium. Final home game of the regular season. It's been senior day, not the way the Weevils have wanted it to go, but you know, you're playing a lot of young players. You got started 2 freshmen at quarterback. He started the ball game with Austin Wadsworth and then Caden has come in. Caden Middleton has come in midway through the first quarter. Done a pretty good job. Look at some of his individual numbers here in the first half, if I can pull them up. For the Weevils, Middleton, 11 of 19, throwing for 129 yards this afternoon with 1 interception and 1 touchdown pass. Gibson. Middleton, 11 of 19, 1 interception and 1 touchdown. So let's see. Wadsworth was 7 of 10 for 133 yards on the afternoon. All right. After the official timeout, Weevil's offense comes out onto the field. 9:12 to play here in the fourth quarter. 34-14 our score. Southern Nazarene with the lead. Caden Middleton, the quarterback. Looks like Furman going to be the lone tailback. Play action. Wanting to roll to his left. Throws back across the middle, and it's in and out of the hands of the intended receiver. That's going to be Mansfield, who is running a drag pattern across the middle of the field. Hit him in the wrong spot, right in the breadbasket. Second down and 10. Clock will stop with 9:07 to play here in the fourth quarter. Weevils moving from right to left, from south to north. as Middleton calling for the snap. Play action again. Throws. This one batted at the line of scrimmage and going to fall to the grass incomplete. As jumping up and getting a hand on it was one of the linebackers there for Southern Nazarene, number 19, Hiram Flores. It'll bring up a third down and 10 now for the Boll Weevils. Twin receivers come wide left. Twins go wide right. Southern Naz going to rush three. Now they bring a linebacker. They rush four. Middleton throws over the middle. This one's complete for a short gain out to the 25-yard line. Going to be well short of the first down. Actually, they'll mark it out at the 26. Mansfield made the catch. And the Weevils are going to have to punt it away again. Here, fourth down and four with 8:40 left to play in the fourth quarter. Trailing 34-14, the Weevils are going to have to punt it away again. This will be the sixth punt of the afternoon for UAM. Back deep, the return man is Joa Flores. A low snap back to Grisotti. He picks it up off the ground, gets the punt away. This one will hit at the 38. And first took a storm bounce back up the field. Then it rolled the Weevils' way back to the 36-yard line. And that's where Southern Nazarene will have it first and 10 here from their own 36. With 8:12 to play in the ball game, leading 34-14. Southern Nazarene's offense will come back out on the field. The backup quarterback, Jarvis Davis, has taken over the duties for them. Gage Porter, the graduate senior, going to get the rest after he contributed almost 300 yards of offense, passing and running this afternoon for the Storm. Handoff goes to the end of the round. As the flag's going to come in, going to be a holding call. Weevils play it out, and they stretch it and throw them for a loss back at the 33-yard line, and then we're going to tack on the penalty. As making the stop, that was Damarian Holmes. He's a senior out of Waco, Texas. He was being hailed. It was right here in front of the whole UAM crowd on the home side. They finally threw the flag, so they'll mark off the penalty against the Storm, and that's going to mark it back to the 26-yard line. Need to get out to the 46. It'll be first and 20 for Southern Nazarene. It would have been second and about 13 if they had taken the play, but the Weevils took the penalty. It'll be first and 20 now for Southern Nazarene from their own 26. Davis takes the snap. Davis hands it off up the middle to the tailback. He's across the 30, out to the 32-yard line. Making the carry that time is Weston Smith. He's going to pick up about six on the play. Yeah, it'll be second down and 14 now for Southern Nazarene. As we go under 7.5 minutes left to play in the ballgame, and Southern Naz leading 34-14. Twin receivers to the left. Twins come wide to the right. On second and long, Weevils. A lot of movement, and they're pointing that say Southern Nazarene had a false start.
False start. Number 75, the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Well, they tab Braden Glover, the big offensive lineman there, the right tackle for moving. He's 315 pounds himself, 6'2", 315. They'll back them up five. It'll be second down and 19 now. They'll spot it back at the 27-yard line. Clock has stopped with the penalty. 7:04 left to go. Southern Nazarene taking their time and calling the play in. Davis, your cornerback. He's the backup. They leave Welch in at the running back spot, and now a timeout called on the field. Southern Nazarene takes the timeout, didn't like what they saw, and they'll take it with them. It's 6:46 to play here in the ball game. It is 34-14. Southern Naz with the lead. We're back with more UAM football after this timeout.
Fans, the UAM Sports Association is the exclusive private fundraising arm of UAM Athletics. Its mission is to raise private funds to support 300 boll weevil and cotton blossom student athletes in competition on and off the field. Annual membership starts at $50. Visit UAMSports.com to learn more about UAM Sports Association. Become a member and make an investment in UAM Athletics today.
It is second down and 19 for Southern Nazarene. Davis wanting to throw. Screen pass back to the other side. A one-handed grab out over the 30, out to the 35, up over the 40. The ball comes loose, and I believe Southern Nazarene has recovered it. As on the catch and run was Weston Smith out of the backfield. Southern Nazarene will maintain possession of it. He's well short of the first down, up at the 40. 2 yard line, needed to get to the 46. The third down and 4 now for Southern Nazarene. Davis again, quarterback draw this time. Davis straight ahead. He's hit at the line. He may have the first down. It'll depend on where they spot the football up at close to the 46 yard line. As we go under 6 minutes left to play here in the contest, they say he did move it up, move the chains. They got it out close to the 47. First and 10 for Southern Nazarene now from their own 47-yard line. So now they'll really start to run that play clock down and try to keep it on the ground, I'm sure. Leading 34-14. Davis has one back. That's Weston Smith in the backfield. Puts a wide receiver in motion. Davis keeps it himself on the quarterback keeper. He's across midfield into Weevil territory, down to the 43-yard line. And that'll be good for 10 yards, 9 yards, and it'll bring up second and one. Nope, they say it's good for the first down, I believe. Let's see. They're going to look at it. They may bring the chains on to measure. Nope. They leave the first down marker back at... Now they move the chain. Chain gang finally decides they'll move. First and 10, Southern Nazarene from the Weevil. 43-yard line. Davis hands off this time to Smith. Smith carries it inside the 40 to the Weevil 39-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 4 on the play. And it'll bring up a second down and 6. As we go under 4.5 minutes left to play here in this fourth quarter, Southern Nazarene leading 34-14 over the Boll Weevils. It was 21-7 at halftime. Southern Nazarene scored twice. UAM scored once here in the second half. On second and 6, Davis fakes the handoff. Now hands it off to the tailback up the middle. As that's going to be number 25, Aaron Welch on the carry. He'll get a yard out of it, down to the 38-yard line. Going to bring up a third down and 5. Now for the Crimson Storm. They go trip receivers wide left on third and 5. Wide receiver screen is going to be complete out there to Donald May. May's got the first down as he'll carry it inside the 35. They'll mark his forward progress right at the first down marker. But they mark him short by half a yard. It'll bring up fourth down and less than a yard. He got a very favorable spot. 3:40 to play. There's a flag on the play, so let's see what that's about. Holding, calling against the offense. It'll remain third down. They'll mark the penalty off against the Storm. So instead of fourth and 1, it's going to end up being third and about, let's see, will they end up spotting the football? They'll spot it back at the 44-yard line. It'll be third down and 11 now for Southern Nazarene. Clock will start after they get the ball set, down to 3:35 and counting. Jarvis Davis looking over the defense, gets the snap, wanting to throw. Davis rolling to his left, going deep down the left sideline, has a man. It's going to be caught at the 10-yard line as he's falling down to make the catch. That is Alan Hernandez, his first catch of the afternoon. It'll be first and 10, first and goal to go from the 10 for Southern Nazarene here. With just over 3 minutes remaining in the contest, the Crimson Storm is going to have it first and goal to go at the 10-yard line, leading 34-14. All right. Play clock down to 15. Clock continue to run. It's down to 2:47 left to play. Davis will line up again in the shotgun. Welch, the lone setback. Wide receiver comes in motion, hand it off to him. He'll try to turn it up at the 10, gets it inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. As coming over to make the stop for the Bowl Eagles, that's Rima Getter. First time I've called his name this afternoon. He's a junior, a 2-year letterman out of Shreveport, Louisiana. The ball carrier that time was Braxton Bird. He gained 3. It'll be second and goal from the 7 now for Southern Nazarene. As we'll go under 2 minutes left to play here in the contest, Southern Nazarene could take a knee and run the clock out, but they probably want to put some more points on the board. They'll come to the line of scrimmage as we go under 2 minutes. Davis calling for the snap. Wide receiver in motion again. Davis keeps it himself at the 5. Davis into the end zone. Touchdown. Jarvis Davis. He's a graduate senior as well. He's a backup quarterback. He goes in from 7 yards out, and it's 40-14. Southern Nazarene extends their lead with a minute 44 to play in the ballgame. They're going to have their backup kicker come in now. This was going to be Carson Seeley. Seeley puts it through the uprights, and it's good. 41-14, our score. Southern Nazarene leads it. A minute 44 to play in the ball game. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the final minute 44 for you in just a moment. Back here at Convoy Leslie Cotton Bowl Stadium, Southern Nazarene leads it 41-14 with a minute 44 to go. They'll kick it off. It'll be fielded by Caleb Jacobs at the 15. Comes to the outside. He's up over the 20 to the 25. He'll make it out to the 27-yard line. And that's where the Weevil offense will take over. First and 10 with a minute 38 left to play here in this contest. Southern Nazarene came into the ball game. Let's get their record for you. I thought I would. They came into the ballgame 4-5. They're going to improve to 5-5. The Weevils are going to fall to 2-8. All right, Caden Middleton, your quarterback, out of the shotgun, takes the snap. He's going to hand it off straight ahead to Furman. Furman across the 30. He'll get out to the 32-yard line, and that's going to be a gain of 4 on the play. It'll be second down and 6. So second down and 6 for UAM from their own 32-yard line. Again, Middleton out of the shotgun. Furman, the lone setback. This time he wants to throw. Pumps, now throws, and going to be incomplete. Intended for Ian Mesh, the tight end running an out route. He was covered up by a linebacker there, number 32. That was Ben Rutherford. The ball actually went off the back of the linebacker. But the incomplete pass will stop the clock with 1:05 left to play. And the Weevils looking at 3rd down and 6 from their own 32-yard line. All right, we're ready to go. 3rd down and 6. Middleton, straight drop. They rush 3, throws it to the sideline, complete to Caleb Jacobs. Jacobs turns it around. He's out over the 37. He'll be out close to the first down marker, I believe. See if they did get it. According to the down marker over there, it's marked out at the 38-yard line. That is good for the first down. So they'll move the chains. Caleb Jacobs, second effort, gets the first down for the Weevils. 1st and 10 from their own 38-yard line, trailing 41-14. Twins to either side now. Now the official stops the clock or stops play. I'm not sure they're looking at the clock. I guess they're going to either put some time back on the clock or take some time off the clock. They're waiting for the play clock to reset, it looks like. Wow. 55 seconds are showing on the game clock. And everybody's still looking at the game clock. And the officials are talking now. 1st and 10, Weevils, from their own 38-yard line. Less than 1 minute to go, trailing 41-14. And they're finally going to let them line up and play football, I think. They put 25 seconds back on the play clock. And 1 minute on the game clock. Okay. So they put 5 seconds back on the game clock here. Middleton calling for the snap. Steps up, forced out of the pocket. Now he's running to his left, and he's going to be hit and dropped for a loss. A flag will come in at the end of the play. As he's hit back at the 34-yard line, that's going to be a loss of 4 on the play against the Weevils. But let's see what the flag is all about. Holding called against UAM. Yeah, decline the penalty. It'll be 2nd down and 14 now for the Weevils as they'll leave the ball spotted at the 34-yard line. 2nd and 14. The clock will start up once they get everything set. Middleton again out of the shotgun calling for the snap. Again, they rush 3. Middleton forced out of the pocket, running to his right, throws it toward the sideline. And let's see, I believe it's going to be caught, but it's going to be for a loss of yardage. Coming back to help out his quarterback was Gibson, Giovanni Gibson. He did make the catch, but he lost yardage back to the 33-yard line, so a loss of a yard on that play. Got out of bounds, and 46 seconds remain. 3rd down and 15. For the Boll Weevils, as they're looking in to Coach Qualls for this play here, as he calls it. Caden Middleton will look over the defense, and now he's calling for the snap. They rush 4 this time. Middleton throws over the middle. It's going to be incomplete, intended for Caleb Jacobs out near midfield. And the incomplete pass will stop the clock with 42 seconds remaining. Weevils will be looking at 4th down and 15. From their own 33-yard line, trailing 41-14. Looks like they're going to leave the offense out there on the field. No. I see Grassati putting his helmet on, and he's going to run out. Back that up. That's not Grassati. That's Ian Mesh, the tight end. Weevils going for it on 4th and 15. Middleton, straight drop, throws it deep down the field. It's picked off at the 40-yard line. Returned up over to the 45, midfield, back in Weevil territory to the 48-yard line of UAM. Coming out with the interception is Aaron Randall. With 26 seconds remaining, Southern Nazarene, all they got to do is come out and snap the football. And this game's going to be over with. 41-14 is the score. As Southern Nazarene's offense comes out, again, all they got to do is snap it and take a knee. As I said, Southern Nazarene's going to improve to 5-5. Weevils are going to fall to 2-8 on the year. Both teams have one final game remaining. Davis goes up underneath center. He'll take the snap and take the knee. This ball game is history. 41-14, our final score, I believe. Wait a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the clock has stopped with 18 seconds left. Now they start the clock back, and the teams start walking toward middle of the field to shake hands. So the final score is 41-14. We'll come back and wrap this one up for you. Southern Nazarene wins it. We'll be back after this timeout. Our final score, 41-14. Southern Nazarene gets the win here this afternoon. As they'll go to 5-5 on the year, the Weevils fall to 2-8 on the season and in conference play. Looking at some of the numbers for you, Southern Nazarene runs 66 plays for 580 yards on the day. They went 12 of 20 passing for 260 yards. And they had 320 yards on the ground. Weevils. Well, the rushing yards, they had 50 on the day, 233 yards through the air. They went 21 of 37 passing with two interceptions, 63 plays, 283 total yards on the afternoon for the Bull Weevils as UAM comes up short here this afternoon. And I said with the loss, the Weevils fall to 2-8 on the day. Southern Nazarene improves to 5-5 on the afternoon. And looking at some individual numbers for you, Gage Porter for Southern Nazarene. He had 20 carries for 132 yards and three touchdowns on the afternoon. He also went 8 of 15 with one interception and two touchdowns, or make it one touchdown through the air. For 8 of 15 for 194 yards, so 132 and 198, he's over 300 yards of total offense for the quarterback for Southern Nazarene. What a day he's had. We'll be glad to see him gone, a six-year senior for them. Be glad we won't have to see him anymore of his career. UAM, Glenn Cage, the leading ball carrier, had 15 carries for 43 yards on the afternoon. Gary Furman, three carries for 19 yards. Caden Middleton, the quarterback, came in there in the first quarter, middleways through the first quarter, ends up going 14 of 27, two interceptions, one touchdown on the afternoon for 157 yards. Austin Wadsworth, who had the start earlier today, he went 7 of 10 for 76 yards through the air for the Boll Weevils. Leading receiver was Arlie Lee. He had five catches for 87 yards. Javonnie Gibson, five catches for 70 yards. Caleb Jacobs, four for 29. And Jordan Manfield, four for 21. Weevils fall here this afternoon by a final score of 41-14. Hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of UAM football here on KHBM 93.7 FM today. Don't forget, our final game of the year comes up next Saturday as the Weevils travel over to Magnolia for the Battle of the Timberlands. That'll be a 1:30 pregame show, a 2 o'clock kickoff next Saturday from Magnolia. For Mr. Jason Camden, our technical engineer back at the station, I'm Jimmy Sledge. Have a great rest of the weekend, everyone. Don't forget, set your clocks back tonight, 1 hour, as daylight saving time expires or ends today at 2 a.m. So set your clock back an hour. That way you won't be wind up being early for church tomorrow. All right, we'll be back next week right here on KHBM. Good night, everyone. Yeah.